put one earplug on and try this one. He says, I sound fine coming to him, but I can't hear one thing I'm saying. Oh, there we go. I can hear myself. Yay. Yeah, I can hear myself now. Can you still hear me, Wes?
Yeah, you sound great. Yeah, there's no compression on your mic, so you're coming in hot and cold. You're bouncing all over the place, so I'm trying to find that happy medium for you.
All right.
We're outside. And then Chris and I are checking the phones. I got everything on auto hold, and it looks like it's working just fine.
Cool. Okay, well. Just understand that this is all improv. We're all doing our best, and so it's okay. You're going to be good. I know you're going to be good, so don't worry about it. We're fine. Yeah, it sounds great, and I think, yeah, it's really good. It's good.
What about Wes?
Wes, how about you? What are you doing? How you sound?
How do I sound? I sound. This is how I sound.
Okay, you sound good. Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
I think I don't mind hearing you loud. You know.
Okay.
Because you're threatening and big, and that's good.
Yeah. So unfortunately, I can only talk to you during breaks.
Okay.
Because if I talk into this, it's going to go over the air. Unless you need me to talk over the air.
No. It'll be fine. Unless I have to call on you. But no, you'll be fine. Just give me.
All right. And I just dropped the best of it, and that should be loaded, but I don't think we're going to need that.
Okay.
But your comments sound good. I'm going to make sure Aftermath is getting audio, and I think it'll be good.
All right. Thank you, man. You're doing a good job. Let's see. We are coming to you live from the Roswell Alien Museum in downtown, beautiful downtown Roswell. Roswell. Hey, guess who made Vanity Fair? Rick Emerson.
Get out of here.
He wrote this new book about, remember Go Ask Alice? He said it was a fake story about Alice, that she didn't do drugs. It wasn't a real story. It was written by some Mormon woman. And so now he's challenging the story, and Vanity Fair did a whole workup on it. So his book's going to sell like wildfire. It's probably going to think make him retire. Oh, no. He calls himself a journalist now.
Hey, Clyde.
Yeah.
So I'm going to keep the Carmex channel open, so you're going to be in you're responsible for muting your mic. Is that something you're capable of doing?
Responsible of muting my mic? No, I can't mute.
Okay. Well, here, I'm gonna play the second montage. I'm gonna turn the mic. I'm gonna turn the Carmex channel on and off. I want to make sure you can still hear it.
All right.
Kendall County, I want to report a UFO. Let me hear the Defense Commander immediately. Don't argue with me, Sarge. Don't you think I know a UFO? I saw it with my own eyes.
You know, there's a new name.
Is it cut in and out?
Unexplained aerial.
Unidentified flying object, popularly called a flying saucer.
Okay, you're going to have to control your headphones in because that's
I've got
Confirmed believers.
We're all part of it.
I saw the movie and read the book.
Yeah, I would say rely on those.
I can hear myself.
I can hear you. Are you talking into the crowd mic right now?
Yes, I am.
No, I mean the other voice I'm hearing. Is it Gene? Okay, he can't hear me. All right. Yeah, that sounds great. I'd say, Clyde, try to encourage people to get on the mic if you can. I will screen calls and do the best I can over here. Okay, but you were able to hear it even. You didn't have any interruptions in audio during that whole time?
No, I heard it fine.
Okay, I'm switching you on and off. Okay, so I'm going to switch you off and I'll put you back on when it's time for you to talk.
All right, thank you.
All right, see you in a bit.
0-0. Zero, zero, UFO, 0-0, UFO. I'm going to maintain the cue anyway. It'll be fine. When I'm talking, the cue will be up. When I'm not, I'll turn it down. I'll be able to maintain it.
Now, 1 minute remaining.
1 minute till air. No, I'm fine. Yeah, I'm fine.
Of the United States. Who is this? Is it you again?
Look behind you.
This is my private line. How did you get through?
They're everywhere. All the time. Receiving every day. But you have to look behind you.
There is nothing behind me. How did you get this number?
The spaceman told me.
What spaceman?
It doesn't matter. They're telling you about the monsters. Please, you must look behind you.
Young lady, there are no monsters in the Oval Office.
The loudspeaker spoke up and said,
"We see me."
The loudspeaker spoke up and said,
"We see me."
The loudspeaker spoke up and said,
"We see
me." Give up.
Give up.
Give up.
Give up. Give up.
We see me. We see me. We see me.
In beautiful downtown Roswell. We're right on the street out in front of the museum tonight, and it's a great time to be outside. It's beautiful here in Roswell, a little warm, but it's kind of cooled down a little bit. I'd like to thank a lot of people who made this happen. Gene Dow, of course, thanks to KSVP FM here in Roswell. Of course, Wes Gottko is back home in Portland, Oregon, running the show for us, and Ron Patton for all he's been doing, and all the other staff at KSVP. All the great sponsors, we may talk about a few of them too, that have fed us and take care of us, and just all kinds of great stuff going on. The hospitality in Roswell is amazing. If you have a way to get out here, please get out here. It's going to be a great time.
A great time.
I have an echo
coming through. Somebody just flipped on
the echo. So, yeah. Thank you. Okay. That just for a minute there, it threw me off a bit. But, yeah, so... It's the reason why we're here is because it is the 75th anniversary of the Roswell incident, and it's great to be able to attend my third outing here. I went back, actually, I was a virtual unknown in 1997, and I managed to get a free trip to El Paso, and I brought a few listeners with me back then. We all went to Roswell. We had a great time during the 50th anniversary. It was a time where UFOs were in the news, especially with the Phoenix Lights and, of course, the 50th anniversary of the Roswell crash And now here we are, 75 years of the Roswell incident. It's great to be able to attend the outing here in New Mexico, observing this celebration, or at least the remembrance of a reported saucer crash on July 8th, 1947. Now, even after 75 years and constant reports of declassified UFO or UAP materials by the Pentagon, the government is still sticking with their 1994 report that eventually was released as case closed. I'm hearing the Ground Zero theme again.
Hello.
I don't know what that's about.
This is the
president. Clyde, stand by. We're having an issue. Your microphone isn't coming over.
Hello, this is the president of the
I'm just going to play some audio until we get that fixed. I apologize.
Who is this? Is it you again?
Look behind you.
This is my private line. How did you get through?
They're everywhere. All the time. We see them every day. But you have to look behind you.
There is nothing behind me. How did you get this number?
It doesn't matter. I'm telling you about monsters. Please, you must look behind you.
Young lady, there are no monsters
in the Oval Office. I can't hear anything. I'm Clyde Lewis, and this is Ground Zero. I hope I'm coming through now. They said that we had a little bit of a microphone problem. I'll be able to probably hear the audio of the music and everything shortly at the moment. You know, when you're doing this live and you're outside and you're trying to get the feed going, it certainly sometimes can give us some technical difficulties, but we're working on those difficulties right now. And hopefully I'll be able to hear the audio back at the studio. But until then, I can hear myself speak. Got a lot of traffic going on out here. We're out in front of the museum, the Alien Museum here at Roswell, New Mexico. And it's the 75th anniversary of the Roswell incident. 75 years ago, of course, July 8th, 1947, it was reported that a flying disc crashed in a place called Corona. The reason why it was called the Roswell incident is because Roswell was the only base that was nearby that could report that something fell out of the sky. And so it was the Roswell 509th Bombing Group. It was a military installation where they used to load atomic bombs onto planes like the Enola Gay. And back in 1995, I was here, or actually 1997, I was here for the first, the 50th anniversary of the Roswell incident. And we discussed, I discussed with people like Don Schmidt and Stanton Friedman and others, just, you know, what happened and why the cover-up. And in 1994, just before the Roswell, 50th anniversary of the Roswell incident, they came up with this case-closed document. Even after 75 years and constant reports, even with the declassified UFO UAP stuff we're hearing about right now in the news, they have not yet opened up the Roswell case. And it's because of a 1994 Air Force report that concluded that the predecessor to the U.S. Air Force, the U.S. Army Air Forces, recovered debris from an Army Air Force balloon. It was a home research project, they said. It was called Mogul. That's M-O-G-U-L, Mogul. And so this report discussed the results of their research, fitting their narrative. And of course, if you go over, and a lot of people won't even take the time to go over the report because it's so it's detailed, but it's flawed. And I've read the report, very flawed, certainly credulous if you look at some of the things they say. It identified some of the, quote, likely sources of where some of these stories about alien bodies and flying saucers crashing. They said that contrary to allegations, many of the accounts, according to them, appear to be descriptions of unclassified and widely publicized Air Force scientific achievements. The bodies, of course, they said, well, the bodies actually were seen, but they weren't alien bodies. Okay, and they wanted to explain, well, what was it? Well, there was a project called High Dive. And there was also, and that with Mogul was their explanation. And they were saying that that the Air Force and their scientific achievements were being misinterpreted. As I said, the bodies, of course, appeared to be actual incidents in which the Air Force members were killed or injured in the line of duty, saying that what happened is that the events of 1947, July 8th, 1947, they were all compartmentalized, and that the events from 1947 were somehow smeared together. Okay? The ideas and the thoughts of what happened back in 47 were smeared together over a 10-year period, creating the Roswell story that we know about, where there was a saucer, a crash, the finding of dead occupants being sent to Air Force Base for evaluation. So according to the report, Air Force activities that occurred over a period of many years have been consolidated and are now represented to have occurred in maybe two or three days in July 1947.
And you are guaranteed a new 99.9% pure silver Morgan dollar. The first time in history this has happened. But with limited quantities, you must call now to order. To learn more, call 1-800-888-7630. If you order now, you will receive a free collector bonus, a $25 value free with every order. Call 1-800-888-7630 now to secure your new Morgan silver dollars before they are gone. 1-800-888-7630.
I had a lady that was in her mid-70s, and I'd sold her timeshare, and that was the lowest I'd ever felt in my life. I knew then that I had to do something to simply not to go to hell for selling timeshare.
Chuck McDowell founded Wesley Financial Group to help folks cancel their timeshares permanently.
Called her and everybody that I had sold timeshare to, and I said, this is what I said to you that was a lie, and this is what you need to do to cancel your timeshare. From that point, people started referring friends to me to help them cancel the timeshare, and that's how it all started. I fought the world's largest timeshare company in federal court. If I had lost that lawsuit, there would be no one helping people that have been lied to when they bought timeshare. I guarantee if we take you as a client, we will cancel your timeshare contract or you'll pay nothing.
Call Wesley Financial Group now for a free information kit. 800-605-5757. That's 800-605-5757. 800-605-5757.
Don't do what I did and run out. If it's working, don't quit. Why undo all the good that's been accomplished?
You've got to feed them right for life.
Dynavite is nutrition.
If I ever took Roy off of Dynavite.
No.
When I get to about 3/4.
When I get down to the bottom of my box of Dynavite. Oh, no. I've got a couple more scoops. It's time to place my order. Dynavite.com. DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
Order a 90-day supply of Dynavite for your dog this week.
We'll send you a bottle of NomoFlea. Free.
NomoFlea flea spray kills fleas safely with no poison.
Because it's a polypeptide protein molecule made from
vegetable oil.
Try NomoFlea.
Free this week at Dynavite.com.
Just feed your dog right. Use Dynavite.
Dynavite for life.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
If your car's no longer covered by a manufacturer's warranty, repairing it can break the bank.
Rebuild, replace transmission, $3,200. Brake system, $1,000. Rebuild, replace.
replace engine, $2,400. The truth is, once your warranty runs out, it's all on you. Every last cent. A vehicle service contract just makes sense. And a vehicle service contract from Toco Warranty makes the most sense. Many other companies hit you with a large down payment. With Toco, there's no down payment. And with Toco, you can pay as you go with affordable payments. Don't waste another minute. Pick up the phone and call Toco right now to start saving big money on expensive covered auto repairs. Prices vary by vehicle. The monthly price for most plans, about the cost of a tank of gas per month. Get your free quote now. Call Toco at 800-897-9537. That's
800-897-9537. We kicked off everything the way we kicked it off, and so we're doing our best here, and you know it works. It's sounding good, isn't it? Yeah, it is. I mean, a few little things here and there, but we're gonna work it out. It's because we're outside. We're out in front of the Roswell Alien Museum in Roswell, New Mexico. KSVP is hosting us tonight. We're very glad that we're here. It's amazing. And as I said earlier, and I don't know how much of the audio you got because we were still figuring it out, but we're fine. I was talking about how, you know, when I first came here, I came to Roswell in 1997. I was still a newcomer to Ground Zero came out in 1995. We did Ground Zero in 1995. I wound up talking with Don Schmidt. I was with Stanton Friedman and the mayor of Roswell. We were in the Roswell, visitor center. I don't think the museum existed at that time. And I was discussing with them the 1994 paper that was released by the Air Force. It was called Case Closed. You can still buy it at the store. Just ask for Case Closed. You buy it online. You buy it at Amazon. And it was this detailed compartmentalization saying that, you know, the Army, Air Force, those who were at Roswell, those who were part of the whole thing, compartmentalized everything, smeared it all together for over 10 years, plane crashes and experiments that were going on, Project Mogul, which was a secret balloon operation, all these things. And so, according to the report, Air Force activities that occurred over a period of many years were consolidated. And they were basically saying that the people that were giving these reports were not to be trusted because this happened over a 2-3 day period, some say even years. And this is from the document. It says, quote, aliens observed in the New Mexico desert were actually anthropomorphic test dummies that were carried aloft by U.S. Air Force high altitude balloons for scientific research. So what is most interesting in this quote is, They're smearing Mogul, which is this balloon project that was very real at the time, and Project High Dive. Now, here's the thing about Project High Dive. Project High Dive, where they dropped the dummies, that was in 1956. High Dive used gondolas and planes to drop the dummies and not balloons. So they had said that, again, let me read that quote. Aliens observed in the New Mexico desert were actually anthropomorphic test dummies that were carried aloft by U.S. Air Force high-altitude balloons for scientific research. So basically, they're smearing the events of Mogul, they're smearing the events of High Dive, and they're saying that the balloons at Mogul were dropping alien dummies or these anthropomorphic dummies, when this didn't happen, this whole High Dive project didn't happen until 1956. So who's lying here? Are the people of Roswell, are the men in the military that had high clearances, that were loading bombs onto planes, were they the ones lying? Did they not know the difference between a weather balloon and a flying disc or something to understand? So going back to 1947, 75 years ago, July 8th, 1947, the Roswell Army Airfield issued a release and said that it recovered a flying disc. Immediately, this fueled a lot of worldwide press attention. Later, it was reported that small bodies were found in the wreckage and that small coffins were ordered and the debris and the bodies were sent to Wright-Patterson Air Force Base. Now, here's the thing that I want to stress to you. They said that what they recovered were little bodies, not alien bodies. Nobody knew what an alien was. That's the thing, is that we've gotten so caught up in our folklore about Roswell. that we just say, with lack of a better explanation, that they recovered alien bodies when the bodies looked like small children. One of the guys I interviewed that flew the wreckage to Wright-Patterson said they looked like little grayish pink children that had died, and the bodies were deteriorating rapidly in the sun. And so they found the bodies, small coffins were ordered, and so how would they all pull this together? How would they all compartmentalize this? Well, I think it's possible, but I think it's highly unlikely. As I was looking over past Roswell reports that I've done, and it's been a while since I've actually opened up the Roswell notes, I actually was going through some documents in Aftermath. And of course, for those of you that don't subscribe to aftermath.media, you should, because you can go in and do your own research of some things, and a lot of overlooked things you find in the aftermath.com, aftermath.media, sorry, the aftermath.media files. And I found this file. It was a report about Jesse Marcel, who was the man that came out with the, well, he came out with the story that a disc had fallen from the skies of Roswell. So there was a picture of Jesse Marcel and General Roger Ramey. And this picture is a well-known picture. It was seen in the Roswell Daily Record. Ramey is holding a memo or a message. And this message is folded in his hand. Now, you can barely make out some of the sentences in the message. But later, using advanced computer imagery, there are those who have deciphered some of the words that were on the memo that may give us clues as to what was happening on that day. Now, enlargements of this memo, and this was something that, you know, I knew existed, but I didn't know what the final results were. And this went in complete detail as to how they were enlarging the memo in the picture because they didn't have the technology to do so in the past. So they enlarged the picture, and they did so they could read what the words said on the memo that he was holding. A guy by the name of Brad Sparks, according to what I was reading, obtained this blow-up and made an attempt to read the memo. And this was in 1980. They tried to decipher what was in the memo. Well, Brad said that what he saw in the memo clearly was the word balloons. Now, in 1985, Sparks was able to pick out a few other words that were unanimously or almost unanimously agreed upon as being words like weather balloons or Fort Worth, Texas. And before you start thinking, well, obviously it was a weather balloon story, no, there was a word that showed up that they found, and that was disc. So not only did we see the words weather balloon in the memo, we saw Fort Worth, Texas, for some reason, was in the memo. Interestingly, they found the word disc in the memo. And so another guy by the name of Jaybon Johnson, he had taken six of the seven photographs in General Ramey's office, including the one which the message might be seen. And so he wanted to take those pictures, and he wanted to investigate further. So what Johnson did is he put together a team to inspect these photographs that included Roger Rager, a space and satellite engineer, and they created a huge enlargement of this photograph. And they had a computer and a variety of software and camera equipment, and they were able to read more of the message that Ramey held, or rather they claimed that they could read it in some degree of certainty. And in the upper left-hand corner, they saw what they believed to be an image of a telephone. And they concluded that this was a telephone message sheet because there was a telephone logo on the paper. And then they claimed to have positively identified a number of words in the message, okay? And there were quite naturally gaps in what they could see, but keywords were the key. Just like weather balloons and disc and Fort Worth, Texas, there were more words that were found that certainly I was completely blown away by what I was reading. And they had different groups go in and look into the Ramey report. And it's an amazing story. We're going to tell you more about that coming up on Ground Zero. 503-225-0860. 503-225-0860. Coming to you live from Roswell, New Mexico. We're Ground Zero. We'll be back. Don't go away.
SRN News, I'm Tayshia Stevens. Texas Governor Greg Abbott not happy with the Supreme Court's remain Mexico policy ruling. The governor says that decision allows the White House border open. The Remain in Mexico program allowed the federal government to hold those seeking asylum in Mexico while an immigration court processed their cases. A special city council meeting in Uvalde, Texas today to discuss issues related to the May 24th Robb Elementary School shooting. The town's mayor said that he believes city leaders are being shut out of the school shooting investigation by the local district attorney. The family of Brian Laundrie will face a jury. A Florida judge denied a motion to dismiss the lawsuit filed by the family of his former fiance, Gabby Petito. The lawsuit claims his family put out a false statement and tried to help their son escape. This is SRN News. I'm Tayshia Stevens.
My brother-in-law died suddenly, and now my sister and her kids have to sell their home. That's why I told my husband we could not put off getting life insurance any longer. An agent offered us a 10-year, $500,000 policy for nearly $50 a month. Then we called SelectQuote. SelectQuote found us identical coverage for only $19 a month, a savings of $369 a year.
Whether you need a $500,000 policy or a $5 million policy, SelectQuote could save you more than 50% on term life insurance.
For your free quote, call SelectQuote at 1-800-928-3355. That's 1-800-928-3355. Or go to SelectQuote.com. 1-800-928-3355. That's 1-800-928-3355.
SelectQuote. We shop. You save. Full details on example policies at selectquote.com/commercials.
Speak.
Lowering your high blood pressure could save you from a heart attack or stroke. If you've stopped your treatment plan, restart it, or talk to your doctor about creating one that works better for you, start taking the right steps at manageyourbp.org.
It's a new life, but I'm going to make it better. I'll come back. Ask your doctor, check your blood pressure.
Brought to you by the American Heart Association, American Medical Association, and the Ad Council.
Uh-oh, Brad's buzzed.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's starting with the woots. And now a speech.
I just want to say that friendship is about heart. Heart and brain. Who's with me?
Good thing is, he knows when he's buzzed.
And my brain is saying, when it's time to go home, somebody call me a ride.
Love that guy.
Me too.
Know your buzzed warning signs? Call for a ride when it's time to go home. Buzz driving is drunk driving. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Did you know that more than half our household energy costs go to heating and cooling? Energy efficiency isn't just good for the environment. It means lower utility bills, too. One way to reduce your energy waste is a home energy assessment. Your utility company can help. Or you can learn how to do it yourself at energysavers.gov. That's energysavers.gov. You'll learn to look for air leaks around windows and doors, check ducts for holes, and improve your insulation. Another time to cut energy costs is when you shop for a new appliance. Look for the Energy Star logo and read the Energy Guide label. And there are day-to-day things you can do. Lower your thermostat in winter and raise it in the summer.
The evidence will be incontrovertible that you will have on your TV screens and on your movie screens concrete evidence that ships are here and that they are real and they're not fantastic things which have been cooked up to make a movie.
After a 1 year's investigation, I believe that the flying saucers seen by veteran airline and Air Force pilots are objects from another planet.
We can say that the recent sightings are in no way connected with any secret development by any agency of the United States.
There's nothing to hide at all.
The Air Force itself has officially admitted that flying saucers exist. This statement appears in Project Saucer Case Number 75. Not only that, the Air Force has officially analyzed the motives of possible visitors in space. Here is a direct quotation from the official report. Such a civilization might observe that on Earth we now have atomic bombs and are fast developing rockets. In the past history of mankind, they should be alarmed. We should therefore expect this time above all to behold such a visitation.
The expression flying saucers is a catch-all term for unusual lights appearing in the sky.
We've been able to explain them as hoaxes, as erroneously identified friendly aircraft, as meteorological or electronic phenomena, or as light aberrations.
I'm Clyde Lewis. You are listening to Ground Zero, coming to you live from Roswell, New Mexico. KSVP, Artesia, KEND, Roswell. We're so glad to be here tonight. Talking to you about, what else, the Roswell event that took place 35 years ago this week. Roswell, New Mexico it's the nativity, I guess, for the contemporary UFO times we're in right now. And it's funny how everything's gone full circle, because it was the military that at Roswell that marked the spot for the first real well-known UFO tale. And now here we are 75 years later, and the same thing is happening, but this time with the Navy. And before it was the Army Air Force, and then, of course, Truman had to create the national security apparatus. Of course, the CIA and the NSA were created after Roswell, immediately after Roswell, actually. And the Army and the Air Force were split. And there were a lot of people who, I guess it was just many years, 30 years after the Roswell incident, they were saying something is not right in the official story of Roswell. In 1994, just before the 50th anniversary of the Roswell crash, the Air Force came forward with a case closed document saying that what people were seeing was some compartmentalized smear of aircraft disasters, anthropomorphic dummies being dropped from an operation called Project High Dive, which was in 1956, not 1947, and something called Project Mogul. This was a balloon type of a top secret situation. And there was, and as I said, as I was doing my research for the shows that we're doing here in Roswell, in the aftermath.media documents, I was able to extract a very interesting story about what is called the Ramey Report. And the Ramey Report was a piece of paper that General Ramey had when the Roswell Daily Record snapped a picture. It says, Ramey empty saucer in Roswell. He's sitting there as Jesse Marcel, is holding up what looks like a weather balloon. And there's a piece of paper on it. And they said, if we were to be able to look at this piece of paper, analyze it, magnify it, we'd be able to figure out just what happened there in Roswell the day that they were trying to tell people that the disc was found or recovered, and then had to turn and change the story to a weather balloon. So, as I said, there was a guy that went, his name was Sparks. He went in, he analyzed the memo. He was able to use technology in the 1980s to bring forward some words off the paper, and some of them were weather balloons, Fort Worth, Texas. But then there was one word that stuck out. That word was disc. Another guy named J. Bon Johnson in 1998 took 6 of the 7 photographs there when Roger Ramey was in that room. Johnson put together a team to inspect the photographs, and as they were explaining them, they looked to the upper left-hand corner of the memo. They saw something that they thought was the image of a telephone, meaning that it was some sort of a teletype telephone message sheet that the higher-ups told General Ramey that he had to say certain things and do certain things. A lot of, I guess you could call them gaps in what they could interpret, because, of course, you know, all the letters were confined together and the words were confined together, but using the technology, they were able to extract more words. Now, this is the interpretation of the message that this group did in 1998. It says this, and this is, now keep in mind, there are gaps, but the words are, they were able to uncover more words as technology improved. Here's the words that were on the memo according to the 1998 findings. It said, as the space, 4 hours, the victims of the space at Fort Worth, Texas, the crash story for 0984 acknowledges emergency powers are needed site 2 southwest of Magdalena, New Mexico, safe talk for meaning of story and mission. Weather balloons sent on the blank and land blank rover cruise, signed Temple. Again, as the blank, 4 hours of the victims of the blank at Fort Worth, Texas, blank, the crash story for 0984 acknowledges blank, emergency powers are needed, site 2 southwest of Magdalena, New Mexico, safe talk blank, for meaning of story and mission, blank, weather balloons sent on the blank and land rover cruise, signed Temple. So, if what they found was accurate and others could corroborate what they had seen, then it was a breakthrough in the Roswell case. And here was a document with an indisputable provenance here, and General Ramey was holding it in his hand, and it was there being seen on the Roswell Daily Record. Holding in his hand, and copies of the photograph put out over the INS wire provided the exact time and date that this was done. And others, as soon as we were seeing more interpretations of that memo, others began to request copies of the pictures from the special collections held at the University of Texas at the Arlington Library. And they brought their expertise in, they brought to bear, because they certainly wanted to find out just what the message was in Ramey's hands. And so, and there were a lot of people that were tickled about this. They were delighted that, you know, we were getting down to the bottom of what really happened in Roswell back in 1947 with this memo. And so, as I said, one researcher looked at the paper, and the letters and the images all came together for them. Yeah, of course, they were interpreting it the way they wanted to interpret, but they never threw out some words that were very important. One of them was discs. The other was incident. The other was victims. There's a whole lot of other things to cover with this memo. It was fascinating stuff. Revealing it here on Ground Zero on the 75th anniversary of Roswell, right here in front of the Alien Museum in Roswell. I'm Clyde Lewis. You're listening to Ground Zero, and we'll be back.
Hey, this is Al Robertson with my dad, Phil. One of the things that we've noticed is, you know, people start losing their hair many times early in life. Now, Dad, you managed to hang on to yours. Have you got some secret?
Yeah, get on this keep, sir. You'll be a hairy guy like me.
I got a little gap coming up on top of mine, so I know the hair loss sometimes can be a touchy subject with guys, and so what Keeps does is help you hang on to your hair. It's clinically proven. It's FDA approved. They have hair treatments available online. They have a physician there, so I want to make sure you get the right product for you, make sure it's safe. There's no waiting rooms. There's no pharmacy visits. Keeps is delivered straight to your door at about half the cost. That's half the cost. If you have any questions, you can message your Keeps doctor 24/7. So if you're a little tired of those balding jokes, go to keeps.com/Phil. 50% off your first order. That's KEEPS.com/Phil, P-H-I-L. Keeps.com/Phil. Hang on to your hair.
Hyperinflation describes out-of-control price increases in our economy. Gold and other precious metals are a defense measure against hyperinflation. Listen to my good friend Alan Johnson from United Gold Group.
80% of all the dollars in existence right now have been created in just the last 2 years. That right there is hyperinflation.
Alan, where will this take us?
With these huge amounts of debt and the vast amounts of currency creation, that's a sign of a fast approaching global bankruptcy. The only two things that cannot bankrupt are an ounce of gold and an ounce of silver.
Call United Gold Group right now. We offer gold and other precious metals delivered securely within 72 hours. Are you worried about inflation? United Gold Group makes gold ownership easy. Call United Gold Group at 800-753-8534. That's 800-753-8534 or visit unitedgoldgroup.com.
Don't do what I did and run out. If it's working, don't quit. Why undo all the good that's been accomplished?
You've got to feed them right for life.
Dynavite is nutrition.
If I ever took Roy off of Dynavite.
No.
When I get to about 3/4.
When I get down to the bottom of my box of Dynavite.
Oh no, I've got a couple more scoops.
It's time to place my order. Dynavite.com.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
Order a 90-day supply of Dynavite for your dog this week.
We'll send you a bottle of NomoFlea free.
NomoFlea flea spray kills fleas safely with no poison.
Because it's a polypeptide protein molecule made from
vegetable oil.
Try NomoFlea
free this week at Dynavite.com.
Just feed your dog right. Use Dynavite.
Dynavite for life.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
If your car is no longer covered by a manufacturer's warranty, repairing it can break the bank. Rebuild, replace transmission, $3,200. Anti-lock brake system, $1,000. Rebuild, replace engine, $2,400. The truth is, once your warranty runs out, it's all on you. Every last cent. A vehicle service contract just makes sense. And a vehicle service contract from Toco Warranty makes the most sense. Many other companies hit you with a large down payment. With Toco, there's no down payment. And with Toco, you can pay as you go with affordable payments. Don't waste another minute. Pick up the phone and call Toco right now to start saving big money on expensive covered auto repairs. Prices vary by vehicle. The monthly price for most plans, about the cost of a tank of gas per month. Get your free quote now. Call Toco at 800.
We're on. I'm just having interesting conversations with the locals here. So just throw rocks at me if I'm not paying attention. But Ron has got the roving mic, and he's walking around. People are. I was just talking with somebody who was in the military, and they were telling me that he was saying he believes it's all real. And he said that there was a news story coming out that I guess Einstein was here in New Mexico during the Roswell. One of his secretaries, I guess, came forward and said something. So that's a new one for me, too. So we're trying to get you all the information. But, Ron, you say you've got some people that want to talk. So why don't we get the microphone out there and get them to talk?
Hi, this is Robert from Roswell.
Hey, Robert. How you doing, man?
Doing good. So, okay, I grew up here, native, family for a long time. And, I mean, we heard little bits and pieces back in the 70s and 80s.
Yeah.
But it wasn't until Don Schmidt that this thing really broke. You know, Kevin Randall and Don Schmidt, I mean, they really broke it open.
Right.
And then all of a sudden, all these old people I grew up with started talking. And so it's interesting they're using technology today to read a letter back then.
Yeah, I mean, as Gene, I was talking to Gene Dowell, and we were talking during the break, and he said, it's fascinating that we have the technology now to go in and take these pictures, you know, that are like 75 years old from a newspaper. They're probably, you remember, they always did the dot matrix type stuff with a newspaper. Being able to take that, analyze it, and try to find out words that were uncovered that he was holding in his hand when they were talking about the Roswell craft.
Well, they would have to use AI to do that.
Yeah.
I mean, really, there's no way a human could do it, but with the development of AI, I mean, we have it doing our astronomy for us. They have it doing all sorts of stuff.
So from the memo, and there's, I got several other interpretations. Some are less intriguing than others. But from the 1998 examination, which I thought was amazing, they said that we had weather balloons, we had disks, and we had incidents being mentioned. Magdalena, Texas, New Mexico, victims, all of these things were mentioned. And so from that, what would your interpretation be?
Well, I don't know what it was, but I can tell you what it wasn't, and that's a balloon. If I put a weather balloon up right here, right now in Roswell, you would have people in Artesia 45 miles away calling saying they see something in the sky.
Right.
It happens all the time. And you're telling me they put this big, giant, giant, reflective metallic balloon up in the air that high? People in Albuquerque could have seen that. I don't know what it was, but I know what it wasn't.
Yeah, that's true. And another thing that really gets on my nerves, and I've talked with Don Schmidt about this, is that now we have the Navy claiming that there's some sort of an alien, not alien, but a UFO incursion going on, right? They go to the Pentagon. The Pentagon says, we've been watching these things for some time. We want to analyze them. Congress wants to analyze them. But back in 1947, when military men, honest military men, who were responsible, they all had clearances, because they were responsible for loading the bombs on the Enola Gay at the 509th, these men had top secret clearances, and you're trying to tell me that they could not tell the difference between a weather balloon that they would know about because it's a secret operation that they'd be doing. They didn't know the difference between a weather balloon and something that's not of this earth or something that they had never seen before?
Well, yeah. I mean, at one point, every atomic bomb in the world basically was in Roswell.
Yeah.
Just about 7 miles down that road right there. And, you know, this was the top line of secure area. And you're telling me that all this stuff happened and everybody that was here that was in charge of our nukes, that was in charge of the 509th, that was in charge of all this was completely stupid and clueless about everything that's going on.
Right.
I mean, they knew everything that was happening in the sky around here. Why do you think you had people come to the desert like with Project Stork and Twinkle and all these things looking for all this stuff?
Right.
The most brilliant minds in the world would not be here for no reason.
Yeah, Von Braun was here, and now we hear Einstein may have been here. Who knows who else was here? And they were witnessing either new technology, which we can't rule out, but just the idea that our military, some of the sharpest and the ones who had had clearance, were not able to tell the difference between a weather balloon and something that would be unknown, I think is doing a disservice to those men. I really do believe that now that we are changing our minds about how the military handles UFOs and UFO stories, I think that posthumously we should apologize to those men, Jesse Marcel and others that came forward and say, look, this deserves to be reopened. We need to look into it.
And people like my grandmother and their generation, who are basically told it's a big desert out there, they'll never find your body.
Yeah.
I mean,
looks like we got another one. Thank you for being a part of the show. I really appreciate it.
Thanks, man. Have a good one. Enjoy your stay.
Oh, it's amazing already. Thank you so much. And who we got on the mic?
How's it going, Clyde? My name's Christian. I'm born and raised here.
Hey, Christian.
So every time I have the chance to listen to your show, it's nothing but 100% great stuff.
Thank you. So I guess you've been hearing this and raised, being raised here. How is it, I mean, generation after generation, we're talking 75 years, you were born and raised here. How does this affect the community, this event that took place back in 1947?
So this event, it's been mugged with a lot of stigma for a lot of people that actually want to believe and want to hear the truth. Nowadays, with everything going on, it's more of a economic type thing.
Yeah.
But, you know, there's a lot of people out there that actually like to look into this a little bit deeper and find out what actually happened out there. What are we not knowing? What's happened? You know, we want to figure that out.
Do you think the mythology and the commercialism of Roswell now is getting in the way of the truth?
Yes, I believe so, 100%.
So serious researchers that come here, you think that they're just overwhelmed with the commercialism? And I heard someone say that this is like Black Friday for people in Roswell, that this is like a boon to the economy once a year.
It is, and to be honest, I see nothing wrong with, you know, getting a little money in your pocket, but sometimes people use it to just for ill-gotten gains, I would say.
Yeah.
That's how I look at it.
As a person who's been born and raised here, a younger generation, what are your thoughts on what happened?
I believe it happened. Without a doubt, I believe it happened. And, you know, a lot of people that I talk to, we go into depth about what actually happened. And there's just so many circumstances and outcomes that we could boil down to. But at the end of the day, we know something happened. And that's just the way how we look at it.
And obviously somebody in your family probably knew somebody who knew somebody that witnessed or at least was aware. I remember back in, 97 when I was here, I talked with a guy who said that I brought up the compartmentalization issue. And he said, oh, yeah, there was compartmentalization, all right, but it was the military that did it. And there were people that were assembling bombs here, and they didn't even realize they were assembling bombs. So we could have easily had a UFO crash here, and they could easily have changed the story over and over again.
To be honest, you know, just my family is a bunch of immigrants. You know, they came over
right
from the south end of the border, and, you know, we made things happen. But just with all that stuff that's happened in the past, we have to look a little bit deeper and understand why that kind of stuff was happening. Was it some kind of preparation that they were doing? You know, I understand at the time the Cold War and all that stuff was going on, but...
Well, it's still, like, it's a wonderful mystery, and it's good to hear an insight from someone who is younger, and I thank you for coming out tonight. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having us.
You
Great
bet.
Show.
We are live in front of the Roswell Museum. Roswell, 75th anniversary of the observance of the crash that happened on July 8th, 1947. We have more on the memo. We have more experiences from people here in the city, in the small town, and we're so happy to be here tonight. Join us for more. We'll be coming back with more from Roswell, New Mexico, right here on Ground Zero.
You have three ex-wives and your current trophy wife wants a life insurance policy three times the size of the policies you had to purchase for your previous mistakes? If so, you need to call Big Lou at Term Provider, 800-333-1750. Big Lou is intimately familiar with your problems, and if you're 50 or 60 years old and in reasonably good health, a $1 million policy should only cost about $100 to $200 per month. Big Lou may have a solution for your previous policies as well. You may even save enough money to lighten the load on your new $1 million policy. Remember, call Big Lou. He's like you, except he's only on number two. Call Term Provider at 800-333-1750. That's 800-333-1750. For $1 million in term life insurance that you can live with, call Big Lou at 800-333-1750. 800-333-1750.
I'm Andrew Saul, Commissioner of Social Security. I'm here to warn you about telephone scammers pretending to be government employees. Some of these scammers may say threatening things like you will be arrested if you don't make payments or provide personal information. Do not fall for these tricks. These calls are not from us. Real Social Security employees will never threaten you for information or money. If you receive a call like this, hang up. Never give the caller your personal information, like your Social Security number or bank account, or send money in any form, cash, gift cards, wire transfers, or prepaid debit cards. Report the call to our enforcement arm, the Office of the Inspector General, at oig.ssa.gov. Share this information with your friends and family.
News this hour from townhall.com. I'm Tasha Stevens. The Supreme Court is putting limits on how the nation's main anti-air pollution law can be used to reduce carbon dioxide emissions from power plants. Job Creators Network President and CEO Alfredo Ortiz tells the Salem Radio Network that he was glad the Supreme Court ruled for small business, not the White House.
I absolutely am. If you look at the other previous decisions where government regulatory overreach was in question, it's all come in favor. And frankly, you know, whether it's greenhouse gas emissions, COVID lockdowns, vaccine mandates, or just a score of other issues, the Biden administration just keeps claiming authority it does not possess.
By a 6-3 vote Thursday with conservatives in the majority, the court said that the Clean Air Act does not give the Environmental Protection Agency broad authority to regulate greenhouse gas emissions from power plants. Well, if you can't get to a doctor to get a COVID vaccine in New York City will come to you via mobile unit.
What we're doing here, other cities can look at and make the determination how they want to address COVID.
That's New York City Mayor Eric Adams. He says the model's the first of its kind that will administer antiviral treatments on site. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis responds to a judge's temporary block on a 15-week ban on abortions in the state. The governor said it will be appealed.
We did have a ruling in Tallahassee effectively enjoining the bill that we provided, that I signed to provide protections for unborn babies at 15 weeks. We knew that that was likely going to be what was decided in that case. We knew that we were going to have to move forward and continue the legal battle on that. And that's something that was decided under state law.
Audio from WFTV. A measure of inflation closely tracked by the Federal Reserve jumped 6.3% in May from a year earlier. More on these stories at townhall.com. I'm Tasha Stevens.
Are you kidding me? Gas prices are up again? Somebody has to do something.
Well, someone did. That's why I use Upside.
Upside? What's that?
It's a free app that pays you back real money for every gallon of gas or diesel you buy. I just earned 25 cents back on every gallon of this tank.
Hold on. So the Upside app is free and you actually get cash back every time you use it? No strings attached?
Yep, it's awesome. Check it out. It only takes a couple of minutes to sign up.
Instead of just watching your dollars go into your tank, start putting money back into your wallet with the free app from Upside. With the price of gas today, it's big news and big money. To cash out of your Upside cash, just transfer to your bank account, PayPal, or a gift card. Upside users have already earned over $200 million. Now it's your turn. Download the free Upside app and get cash back on every gallon of gas. Use promo code CLOCK for an extra 25 cents per gallon on your first fill up. That's code CLOCK. Use code CLOCK for an extra 25 cents per gallon back in your first fill up.
North Texas parents are denouncing a new student dress code for the fall term.
Students in Forney, 20 miles east of Dallas, will be prohibited from wearing hoodies, denim, dresses, or skirts, along with anything with logos, stripes, or checks, as well as t-shirts and baseball caps when school starts in 2 months. Also banned cargo pants, sunglasses, zippered shirts. District officials say the new rules will improve self-esteem, bridge socioeconomic differences, and promote positive behavior. But parents are outraged, saying the new code limits creativity and is overly restrictive. Rhonda Rockster reporting.
San Diego Comic-Con will give William Shatner fans a chance to see their guy. The 91-year-old actor plans to debut a documentary about his life at the event. During a convention panel next month, fans will be the first to see footage from that documentary. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Tayshia Stevens. A Texas woman suspected in the fatal shooting of a professional cyclist is arrested in Costa Rica.
The U.S. Marshals Service announcing that 34-year-old Caitlin Marie Armstrong was arrested Wednesday at a hotel in Provincia de Puntarenas. Armstrong was expected to be returned to the U.S., where she faces a murder charge. Anna Mariah Wilson was found dead May 11th, and police later issued a murder warrant for Armstrong. Wilson, a competitive gravel and mountain bike racer and Vermont native known as Mo, had been in Austin, Texas for a cycling event. John Scott reported.
An investigation is underway into the fatal shooting of a young mother in New York City last night. Police say the 20-year-old woman was pushing her three-month-old baby in a stroller on Manhattan's Upper East Side when a man approached from behind and shot her in the head. The baby was unharmed. More on these stories at townhall.com. I'm Tayshia Stevens.
Duplication, nude conspiracies. Oh my God.
Clyde Lewis
was right.
The loudspeaker spoke up and said,
"We see you."
The loudspeaker spoke up and said,
"We see
you." The loudspeaker spoke up and said,
"We see you."
Give up. I'm Clyde Lewis, and this is Ground Zero. The numbers to call tonight, 503-225-0860. That's 503-225-0860. Yes, we are taking calls. We're hoping to get you on the air with the show tonight. We are coming to you live from Roswell, New Mexico. KSVP, Artesia, KEND, Roswell. And they're hosting us tonight, and we're right in front of the UFO Museum, right on the main drag here in Roswell, New Mexico. And, yeah, they're all, like, revving their engines, and so if you hear them in the background, it gives a little authenticity to what we're doing tonight. It's important that we're here. I was here, as I said, in the last hour. I was here with the 50th anniversary back in 1997. And it was a very historical time, especially for UFO sightings. Phoenix Lights, and there were a number of things that happened in 97. Heaven's Gate cult. I mean, just go down the list of all the things that were just crazy were happening in 97. It was a time the Air Force decided to publish a 1994 report saying that the Roswell case had been closed. But in the annals of American history, and when you're looking at Cold War conspiracy theory, few incidences have inspired much fascination and speculation in the Roswell crash of 1947, 75 years ago this week. It began in the summer of 1947, and as I said, you know, many times, Cold War conspiracy theories are the things I really love to talk about because they're rich in history. And the U.S. Army Air Force, they were combined at the time, sent out a shocker of a press release announcing that they'd recovered a flying disc from a ranch near Roswell, New Mexico. More than 75 years later, this incident remains a defining aspect of this part of the country's identity. And you can see it when you go down the streets here. You can see aliens everywhere, alien lampposts. The Dunkin' Donuts sign is a big alien. You see aliens at the gas station. It's just a lot of fun to be here. So it's the identifying thing with this area of the country. And there's a reason for this. The UFO Museum is amazing. We're going to be broadcasting inside there tomorrow. The research center is amazing because you get to go in and you tour and you see all the stories and you get all the artwork and everything. And behind all of the UFO mania and everything that you've heard about Roswell, there is this uneasy, inconvenient truth, and that is the events that transpired that summer 75 years ago are not clear-cut, and I think they're not clear-cut for a reason. There's a lot of cover-up, a lot of Cold War intrigue, a lot of men in black, a lot of death, a lot of threats of death, and a lot of admitted cover-ups and conflicting explanations. It was either a saucer, it was a German warcraft, it was a spy craft, it was the Soviet Union. I mean, there's so many different theories and ideas, and literally there's some that are still emerging. Mac Brazel, of course, was the farmer that found the wreckage. Actually, they found the wreckage on a property out there in Lincoln County. It was called it was the Foster Farm. I think it was called the Foster Farm. Yeah, Max Brazel, Foster Farm. I'm just going here by recollection here. I could be wrong, but anyway. So the story of Max Brazel finding all of this wreckage in this area of Lincoln County, New Mexico, it was 75 miles north of Roswell. It's about an hour or two drive to go to the crash site. And flying saucer stories started appearing in the press. And it was very shocking because everyone was wondering what's going on. It was Sheriff George Wilcox. He was involved. He was the sheriff there. There was Jesse Marcel. There was General Ramey. There was all kinds of people that were there at the Roswell base talking about this situation. And the RAAF released a statement, and they said that the many rumors regarding the flying disc became a reality yesterday when the intelligence office at the 509th Bomb Group of the 8th Air Force Roswell Army Field was fortunate enough to gain possession of a disc through the cooperation of one of the local ranchers in the Sheriff's Office of Chavez County. So according to the statement, Major Jesse Marcel, who was an intelligence officer, oversaw the RAAF's investigation of the crash, recovered materials, and the following day, the Roswell Daily Record ran a story about the crash and the RAAF's astonishing claims that they found a disc. But then something happened. The U.S. Army officials, or the Army Air Force officials, they did an about-face, they reversed their story, and they said, it's not a flying saucer. The debris we found was that of a weather balloon. And then they released photographs of Jesse Marcel posing with a weather balloon, these pieces of aluminum foil and flimsy stuff. And in fact, I was looking at a headline here, kind of clever. It says, Army disc counts New Mexico find as weather gear. And for decades, there have been, well, 75 years, of course, there have been UFO researchers that have been skeptical of the changed account. 1994, of course, they gave their account that there were a number of things involved. Project Mogul, which is a weather balloon secret type of project. And then, of course, it was Project High Dive, where they were dropping these anthropomorphic dummies over white sands. And, of course, that happened in 1956. It didn't happen in 47. But the military, the government had said in their report, saying, well, they all smeared it together, compartmentalized it together. What they remember were crashes of aviators. What they remember was the Project Mogul balloon situation. What they remember were bodies of these soldiers, and they remember the anthropomorphic dummies that were dropped out of the planes, that were dropped out of gondolas on these planes. And it just sounded so far-fetched. And it sounded like the government itself, the Pentagon and whoever else was involved, sounded like they were smearing the story together, not the other way around. And they did it because of an agenda. Of course, they did it because they wanted to cover up something. And the thing that's so interesting about the Roswell case is that if you remember, and there's so many comparisons to what's going on now with the military and UFOs. If you remember when we started hearing about the military buzzing, the Tic Tacs buzzing, the Navy, President Trump created the Space Force, just like President Truman created the Army Air Force, or he separated the Army and the Air Force. Truman also created the security apparatus with the NSA and the CIA. Now, why do we need a security apparatus after Roswell? Well, maybe something got loose. See, that's the thing, is that so many things happen directly out of Roswell, and it just certainly is important to revisit this. Now, one of my favorite people in the whole world, Donald Schmidt, is going to be coming on to explain. He's been investigating Roswell forever. The guy doesn't age. I think, I don't know what he does. I always like to kid him by how he looks like, probably the best-looking UFO investigator out there. But he is. I mean, and with me sitting next to him, he's even better looking. But anyway, Donald Schmidt coming up on Ground Zero. And we're live in Roswell, in front of the Roswell Museum. We're so happy to be here. Donald Schmidt coming up on Ground Zero. Don't go away.
Mike Cappell here, serial entrepreneur with words from another happy payroll customer.
Patriot Software has saved our business by allowing me to focus on other aspects of the business rather than spending so much time on multiple platforms to do the things entailed on running a business. I found Patriot by complete accident, and I don't regret it. It is continuing to save our company, and I'm extremely excited to see what else it entails.
Easy to learn, easy to use, small business software tailored just for you. Oh, 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 oh.
Visit us at patriotsoftware.com. Promo code radio and get 2 months of payroll free. That's patriotsoftware.com.
With patriotsoftware.com, accounting and payroll, keep your time and money.
Paid for by GovMint.com.
Have you heard? The United States Mint has issued the Morgan Silver Dollar for the first time in 100 years. Not only that, but they are also minted in 99.9% pure silver for the first time ever in history. Coin experts are calling this an amazing opportunity for anyone that knows the enduring popularity of Morgans. But you must hurry. Only 175,000 legal tender silver dollars were issued. These Morgan Silver Dollars are brand new, bright and shiny legal tender coins minted by the iconic Philadelphia Mint. Just call 1-800-888-7630 and you are guaranteed a new 99.9% pure silver Morgan dollar. The first time in history this has happened. But with limited quantities, you must call now to order. To learn more, call 1-800-888-7630. If you order now, you will receive a free collector bonus, a $25 value free with every order. Call 1-800-888-7630 now to secure your new Morgan silver dollars before they are gone. 1-800-888-7630.
Don't do what I did and run out. If it's working, don't quit. Why undo all the good that's been accomplished?
You've got to feed them right for life.
Dynavite is nutrition.
If I ever took Roy off of Dynavite.
No.
When I get to about three quarters.
When I get down to the bottom of my box of Dynavite.
Oh, no. I've got a couple more scoops.
It's time to place my order. Dynavite.com.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
Order a 90-day supply of Dynavite for your dog this week.
We'll send you a bottle of NomoFlea free.
NomoFlea flea spray kills fleas safely with no poison.
Because it's a polypeptide protein molecule made from
vegetable oil.
Try NomoFlea
free this week at Dynavite.com.
Just
Just feed your dog right. Use Dynavite.
Dynavite for life.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
Dinovite .com.
If your car's no longer covered by a manufacturer's warranty, repairing it can break the bank.
Rebuild, replace transmission, $3,200. Anti-lock brake system, $1,000. Rebuild, replace engine, $2,400.
The truth is, once your warranty runs out, it's all on you. Every last cent. A vehicle service contract just makes sense. And a vehicle service contract from Toco Warranty makes the most sense. Many other companies hit you with a large down payment. With Toco, there's no down payment. And with Toco, you can pay as you go with affordable payments. Don't waste another minute. Pick up the phone and call Toco right now to start saving big money on expensive covered auto repairs. Prices vary by vehicle. The monthly price for most plans, about the cost of a tank of gas per month. Get your free quote now. Call Toco at 800-897-9537. That's 800.
I'm Clyde Lewis. You're listening to Ground Zero. We're coming to you live from Roswell, New Mexico. We're in front of the Roswell Museum and the Study Center. Sitting to my left is one of the most remarkable men I've ever known in the UFO business. I met him in Roswell in 1997. He was the only guy that talked to me, actually. Everybody else thought, who the hell is this guy? But yeah, because I was a virtual.
I felt sorry for you.
Yeah, you felt sorry for me. I thought, you know what I thought? This guy looks important. Maybe I'll talk to him.
Touche.
Anyway, but Stanton was standing right there too, remember? Stanton
oh, yes,
was there.
That's right, yes.
Yeah, so, okay. So,
Stan and I always stood together.
Yes, you did.
And as Stan, as he got older, he would always, Don, hang with me.
Yeah.
Because I'd always be mouthing him answers,
yeah,
like during press conferences.
You're like Cyrano de Bergerac.
That's right, Stan. That's right.
That's where you were. Yeah, Donald Schmidt has been a big friend of Ground Zero for a long time. We've talked. I've been here three times. This is my third time. Lucky to be here on the 75th as well as the 50th. You and I have talked a lot. Of course, you've been involved with special investigations over the years with Roswell, the J. Allen Hynek Center for UFO Studies, Project Blue Book.
Right, right.
Let's go down all the lists that you've been involved with. Of course, you worked with Kevin Randall. You made the Golden Globe-nominated Best Made-for-TV movie, Roswell. You're the co-founder of the International UFO Museum and Research Center here in Roswell. Has the largest UFO literary area in the whole world, and just so many good things. Don, welcome back to Ground Zero.
Oh, so good to be back, Clyde, and so happy to have you back here in Roswell. Might I quickly say something about the Golden Globe ceremonies?
Okay.
Just imagine, we have the premiere of our Roswell movie, mm-hmm. made-for-TV movie with Showtime, back in 1994. And they were so impressed with the way the movie was going down.
Yeah.
They decided to film in 35 millimeter. Because there was a limited feature run in LA, New York, Washington, Chicago, that type of thing.
Yeah.
And when we were nominated, Best Made for TV Movie, Golden Globes, we were invited. I mean, it was based on our first best-selling book, UFO Crash at Roswell. Mm-hmm. And all of Hollywood, I mean, it's bigger than the Academy Awards. And where are we that night? We're not in Hollywood. We're in Albuquerque, New Mexico at the Ramada Inn, sitting in the lobby, watching, looking at one another, Kevin Randall and myself going, this is the stupidest thing we have ever done in our lives. We were working on the case. We were here,
yeah,
you know, devoted and committed to keep, you know, the ball rolling.
Right.
Racing with the Undertaker, as we often would say.
Right.
And I still look back. What are the chances we're going to ever have
that
opportunity?
True, is you get so ensconced in what you do, and it's like, I don't got time to go to Hollywood and mingle. I just got to get the work done and continue to get the work done. And, you know, one of the, I guess, great things about you being here and still telling the story is that, as I was saying to you before you went on the air tonight, I said, you know, I was going over some of my old Roswell notes, and I'm thinking, you know, how many times can I talk about Roswell and make it interesting?
Mm-hmm.
Because there was, oh, yeah, it's Roswell. What is Roswell? I stumbled upon the Ramey memo.
Correct.
And the investigation of the Ramey memo. And I remember the picture
yes.
of General Ramey and Marcel mm-hmm. and how he had that memo in his hand.
Right, right.
And I remember actually trying to read it.
Yes, yes.
And not being able to read, because I wanted to know what it said on that piece mm-hmm. of paper. And I thought, this is the story, because I haven't talked about it with you, but I know that you were involved.
Oh, yes.
With one of the investigations in the very beginning.
Yes.
And I read some of the interpretations. Mm-hmm. I'll go over them again with you. But when did you first, was it 1982,
3? 89.
It was 89.
89.
Okay.
And then we discovered, well, let me first set it up. What had happened?
All right.
Okay. The Roswell Army Airfield puts out that press release at noon Mountain Standard Time on Tuesday, July 8th. That the point being, the first atomic bomb squadron in the world mm-hmm. announces they've captured a flying saucer.
Right.
And the very base commander, Colonel William Blanchard, his boss was General Roger Ramey, head of the 8th Air Force.
Right.
At Carswell Army Airfield in Fort Worth, Texas. So they order Major Jesse Marcel, who was the head of intelligence of the 509th, the atomic bomb wing, to take some of the wreckage directly to Wright Field in Dayton, Ohio, to be tested, analyzed. It was a precursor to Area 51. 51 right. didn't even exist for another, 8 years.
Right.
And so it was a B-29 bomber that left at 3 o'clock that same afternoon, 3 hours after the press release. And they're on their way to Wright Field. Well, halfway across the country, they're diverted down to Texas. So it wasn't as though this was planned, but General Ramey had the plan that we're going to have a press conference and we're going to catch the intelligence officer Marcel unprepared. And he already has some of the actual wreckage.
Yeah.
And we're going to announce that Marcel is going to be bringing pieces of the flying saucer with him to this press conference. So the flight's diverted. They land in Fort Worth.
Yeah.
Marcel is ushered to General Ramey's office. He places some of the actual debris, the wreckage, on his desk. And Ramey takes him to a map room, check out some of the locations involved. And when they return, the material is gone. Everything's missing. But on the floor, in place of it, is a clump of rotting neoprene rubber weather balloon and a shredded radar reflector kite. So rubber, foil, mm-hmm. wooden sticks, string, and tape. Off-the-shelf material that any child would recognize.
Right.
There's a hallway of reporters waiting to come in and see the pieces just arrived from Roswell of the flying saucer. Well, Ramey then will only allow a single reporter by the name of James B. Johnson of the Fort Worth Star-Telegram.
Right.
And Marcel is immediately ordered to crouch down and hold up pieces of the kite. Those are the famous pictures that went all around the world. Well, in subsequent pictures, General Ramey, in two separate shots by himself, and then two more of himself and his chief of staff, Colonel Thomas DeBose, are pictured, and Ramey is holding a piece of paper. What's interesting is that in three of the shots, it's the blank backside of the paper. In the one, you can see an entire paragraph of text.
Yes.
And it's obviously a telex. Mm-hmm. And so when we learned in the summer of 1989 that those negatives still existed, we immediately put in a request for copies.
Right.
And so we acquired them, and we're looking at that one, and we're going, at that time, you're talking 1990, my God, we're just on the cusp of being able to read this.
Right.
And at the time, we didn't have all the software, we didn't have anything aside from just computer enhancement. So I had contacted Dr. Richard Haynes, who was consulting with NASA. He was working at JPL in Pasadena at that time. Mm-hmm. Dear friend. Wonderful as far as photographic analyst, and his work as far as on pilot cases since World War II is on beyond anyone's other research.
Right.
Well, anyway, we had him attempt enhancement on the memo, and he was only able to come out with one word, and that was the word balloon.
Yeah.
So we immediately thought, well, just as we suspected, it's a press release on the weather balloon. Mm-hmm. Nothing more.
Right.
And that's where it stood. for the next few years, and then as specifically Dr. David Rudiak and Dr. Donald Burleson, we acquired scans from the original negative, and then we were able to increase the pixel dot as far as enhancement.
Right. We're going to take a break right now. Donald Smith's with us, talking about the Ramey memo. This is something I haven't explored, but rediscovered looking over some documents. Don Schmidt was responsible for investigating this, and we're going to find out, get down to the bottom, what's on the Ramey memo the day the saucer crashed in Roswell. We'll be back with more. 503-225-0860. 503-225-0860. Live from Roswell, I'm Clyde Lewis. This is Ground Zero, and we'll be back.
SRN News, I'm Tayshia Stevens. The Supreme Court says the Biden administration can scrap a Trump-era immigration policy that had immigrants waiting in Mexico for hearings in U.S. immigration courts. Two conservative justices joined their three liberal colleagues in siding with the White House. Companies that want to sell shampoo bottles, food products, and other items wrapped in plastic in California going to have to cut down on their use of the material. That's under a bill signed Thursday by Governor Newsom that sets the nation's most stringent plastics reduction rules. It would require producers to use 25% less plastic for single-use products. Big Ten votes to add USC, UCLA as members starting in 2024. The announcement comes almost a year after Oklahoma and Texas formally accepted invitations to join the Southeastern Conference in July 2025. This is SRN News.
The word is out. People are abandoning their overpriced wireless carriers and flocking to PureTalk for the same 5G coverage, but at a fraction of the price. In fact, the average family saves over $800 a year when switching from Verizon, AT&T, or T-Mobile. And switching is so easy. You can keep your phone, keep your number, or get huge discounts on the latest iPhones and Androids. Right now, you can get unlimited talk, text, and 6 gigs of data for just $30 a month. Or if you still want unlimited data, you can get that and still save a fortune. So make the switch and get the same coverage as the big guys, but at half the price. Go to puretalk.com, type in your address to find the coverage at your home, then enter promo code HALFOFF, and you'll save an additional 50% off your first month. That's puretalk.com, promo code HALFOFF. Switch to PureTalk and get unlimited talk, text, and 6 gigs of data for just $30 a month, because PureTalk is simply smarter wireless.
Speak.
Lowering your high blood pressure could save you from a heart attack or stroke. If you've stopped your treatment plan, restart it, or talk to your doctor about creating one that works better for you, start taking the right steps at manageyourbp.org.
It's a new life, but I'm going to make it better. I'll come back. Ask your doctor, check your blood pressure.
Brought to you by the American Heart Association, American Medical Association, and the Ad Council.
Uh-oh, Brad's buzzed.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's starting with the woots. And now a speech.
I just want to say that friendship is about heart. Heart and brain. Who's with me?
Good thing is, he knows when he's buzzed.
And my brain is saying, when it's time to go home, somebody call me a ride.
Love that guy.
Me too.
Know your buzzed warning signs? Call for a ride when it's time to go home. Buzz driving is drunk driving. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Did you know that more than half our household energy costs go to heating and cooling? Energy efficiency isn't just good for the environment. It means lower utility bills, too. One way to reduce your energy waste is a home energy assessment. Your utility company can help. Or you can learn how to do it yourself at energysavers.gov. That's energysavers.gov. You'll learn to look for air leaks around windows and doors, check ducts for holes, and improve your insulation. Another time to cut energy costs is when you shop for a new appliance. Look for the Energy Star logo and read the Energy Guide label. And there are day-to-day things you can do. Lower your thermostat in winter
and raise it in the summer. Close fireplace dampers when they're not in.
Kettle Party, order report a UFO. Let the Air Defense Command immediately. Don't argue with me, Sarge. Don't you think I know a UFO? I saw it with my own eyes.
You know, there's a new name. It's unexplained aerial phenomenon.
This is a UFO, unidentified flying object, popularly called a flying saucer. UFO sightings persist, and skeptics often become confirmed believers. Confirmed believers. Confirmed believers.
I saw the movie and read the book.
We're all a part of it.
I saw the movie and read the book.
A UFO scare throughout the world.
Unexplained aerial phenomenon.
This is EST. We're making Kilo 157 a special 13, which is the classification for unsafe target.
Impossible, unbelievable, fantastic. But I tell you, it could happen. It could happen. It could happen. It could happen.
Yes. Where is he from? I don't know. It did not look like a different event. And now the dog wants a space man. If he thinks he's second size, I'm sorry, it happened with my own eyes. A million miles from the midway, hundreds of mothers in zero.
There are many high-ranking military, aviation, and government officials, many of whom are here today to share my concerns.
20,000 feet, low
cheap,
snap. 270, over.
Bearing 270, 31 miles.
Are you going to commit more resources to exploring UFOs and open the documents to the public?
Well, I'll do whatever you ask me to do, including total transparency. And I got to tell you, there's probably some pretty good transparency needed there.
UFOs are as real as the airplanes flying over your head.
I'm Clyde Lewis. What's that? Don Schmidt's with us. What were you saying?
A little bit of everything.
I know,
all
we just saw.
Is a helicopter.
That was a strange sounding police car. It sounded like a UFO. Now we know where the aliens are. They're in the police cars.
They're in the police cars.
That's crazy. Okay, so Don Schmidt's with us. I was hanging on to every word here about this memo, this Ramey memo. Of course, they found the words weather balloon, and they thought,
balloon.
Oh, it was balloon.
Just balloon.
Not weather balloon.
Not weather balloon.
So it was balloons or balloon. Okay, so, yeah, balloons. And then after you were saying that J. Bon Johnson, the guy who took the pictures, he submitted more negatives to you guys.
Well, no. Though we had found Johnson, he was living in... Palm Beach at that time.
Okay.
And the Bettman Archive Library Collection in Bettman, Texas,
right,
actually has the negatives. Six of the seven,
right,
in their possession. The one particular photograph of the weather officer, Irving Newton, we've never been able to track down. And we believe that the public information officer at Fort Worth at that time, who was a Major Charles A. Cashin, took a number of the pictures. But the ones that hit the stands, hit the newspapers, were taken by Johnson.
Okay.
Because he's the one who put them on the wire service that evening, yet when he got back to the paper.
So after you did your first initial, examination of the memo with the new technology you had,
I was reading that what happened is you finally, after, I think it was it 1998?
It was right after the 50th anniversary.
Yes, exactly. 97, 98. You guys decided to go in again. You did some more investigating, and you found on the paper what looked like a telephone.
Well, but what also helped was that we actually were able to get scans from the original negative.
Right.
So we increased the PSI as far as of the negatives. So for all intents and purposes, we had more pixel dots than were even in the original negative.
Right.
But the problem with that was that in making attempts to, again, enlarge, and like Dr. David Rudiak from the San Francisco area, by blowing up the negative to the point that things would become more legible, as you, and I would discuss this with Ray Downing at Studio Macbeth in New York,
right,
who did the 3D imagery on the Shroud of Turin.
Yes.
And they had the exact same problem, that as you increase as far as the enhancement or even the enlargement of the image, you also increase the noise.
Yes.
With the shroud, it was the fabric, and with the negative, it was just the grain from the original photograph.
Right, because it would be difficult to get it from the Roswell record because they would pixelate everything anyway.
Exactly, exactly.
And so you get a bunch of dots. But then as you move in again, it became quite clear, and this is what I got from the document that I was reading, all in capital letters. It's, as the blank, 4 hours, the victims of the blank at Fort Worth, Texas, the crash story, for 0984 acknowledges blank, emergency powers are needed, site 2, southwest of Magdalena, New Mexico, blank, safe talk for meaning of story and mission, blank, weather balloon sent on the and land rover cruise, signed Temple. What do you make of that?
That was one of the first interpretations. And then, and that was mostly by Dr. David, or Donald Burleson.
Yeah.
And it was Dr. David Rudiak who spent years, and in his case, he would have it blown up on the wall in front of him to the point that, and for those who have argued that we're just chasing, you know, as far as faces in the clouds.
Right.
Well, there's an endless number of possibilities. With this, there's only 26 possibilities as far as letters go.
Right.
And then it has to be coherent, and then it has to also be of military jargon. What was the, as far as the verbiage used at that particular time? And if it is a telex, it would be very curse, very short, to the point.
Right.
And as a result, the interpretation of Dr. Rudiak finally released was about 75% interpreted. But the crucial line is still, victims of the wreck, you forwarded to blank blank at Fort Worth, Texas. And that ties in exactly in a reason that we had already been able to come up with witnesses who described specifically a flight that went out that transported bodies directly to Fort Worth.
Right.
So it all came together in that regard. And it wasn't where Rudiak or anyone else was aware that we were going in that direction, because we were still holding on to information for as a control.
Mm.
It's one of the reasons that even the museum here, we have yet to present an accurate portrayal of the bodies, lest we will potentially contaminate or coach any possible witnesses.
Right.
Now that the race with the Undertaker is over, and now we would change that.
Right.
But we have one of the props from the Roswell movie, one of the bodies. And even at that time, we made sure that the body did not resemble the eyewitness accounts. And so when people have described that very body, we know they're not genuine. And I think that's what, you know, legitimate professional investigative methodology, you hold on to as much controlled information as you can.
Yeah, that's one of the things I think people need to remember, is that when those bodies were found, they weren't called aliens.
Exactly.
They weren't called aliens. We'll get back with more from Don Schmidt right here on Ground Zero, live from Roswell, New Mexico, in front of the Roswell Alien Museum. Very glad to be here tonight. Of course, the 75th anniversary of Roswell. We're back with more. Don't go away. Thank you. It's that time of the year again. Pollen in the air, smoke in the air from all the fires. Well, you can purify the air in your home and get healthy, clean, fresh-smelling air. Eliminate odors, kill mold, mildew, and bacteria and viruses. You do it with the Eden Pure Thunderstorm Air Purifier. It uses oxy technology that naturally sends out O3 molecules into the air, which seek out odors and air pollutants in your home and destroys them. It doesn't mask or cover up bad odors and pollutants. It eliminates them. It's called the Thunderstorm because it purifies the air in your home and provides you with pure, fresh air just like after a thunderstorm. Right now, you can save $200 on an Eden Pure Thunderstorm 3-pack for a whole home protection. You'll get 3 units for under $200. That's a fraction of the cost compared to other air purifiers. It can go for over $600. Put one in your basement, bedroom, family room, kitchen, or anywhere you need a clean, fresh air place. This is a special offer, and you're getting 3 units for under $200. Go to EdenPureDeals.com and put in discount code Clyde3 to save $200. That's EdenPureDeals.com, discount code Clyde3. Shipping is free.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack. Sure, you can post your job to some job board, but then all you can do is hope the right person comes along. Which is why you should try ZipRecruiter for free at ZipRecruiter.com/free.
That's right, free. The smartest way to hire. Just go to this exclusive web address, ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Hey, it's Clyde. We've been listening to you about the downturn in the economy. It's made it tough for Americans. We realize this. So we've decided to drop the membership prices for new subscribers to our exclusive digital playground, Aftermath.media. If you want only the archive shows, it's only $59 a year now. For access to the archives, research groups, chats with me, and bonus features, it's just $79 a year. That's a savings of almost 55% off the regular price. It's for a limited time, so sign up now at aftermath.media. That's aftermath.media.
Don't do what I did and run out. If it's working, don't quit. Why undo all the good that's been accomplished?
You've got to feed them right for life.
Dynavite is nutrition.
If I ever took Roy off of Dynavite.
No.
When I get to about 3/4.
When I get down to the bottom of my box of Dynavite.
Oh, no. I've got a couple more scoops.
It's time to place my order. Dynavite.com.
D-I-N-O-V-I-T-E .com.
859-428-1000.
Order a 90-day supply of Dynavite for your dog this week.
We'll send you a bottle of NomoFlea free.
NomoFlea flea spray kills fleas safely with no poison.
Because it's a polypeptide protein molecule made from
vegetable oil.
Try NomoFlea
free this week at Dynavite.com.
Just feed your dog right. Use Dynavite.
Dynavite for life.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
Dynavite.com.
Manufacturer's warranty. Repairing it can break the bank. Rebuild, replace transmission, $3,200. Anti-lock brake system, $1,000. Rebuild, replace engine, $2,400. Truth is, once your warranty runs out, it's all on you. Every last cent. A vehicle service contract just makes sense. And a vehicle service contract from Toco Warranty makes the most sense. Many other companies hit you with a large down payment. With Toco, there's no down payment. And with Toco, you can pay as you go with affordable payments. Don't waste another minute. Pick up the phone and call Toco right now to start saving big money on expensive covered auto repairs. Prices vary by vehicle. The monthly price for most plans, about the cost of a tank of gas per month. Get your free quote now. Call Toco at 800-897-9537. That's
we are live from Roswell, New Mexico. And we're so glad to be here with Donald Schmidt and getting down to the bottom of the Ramey memo, something that I've not talked about in the many years I've talked about Roswell, and knowing that Donald was involved with the investigation and knowing that, you know, there are words that were there that would indicate that something from on high was being sent to Ramey, telling Ramey, you have to come up with a new story because we don't want anything getting out about what happened. And especially the technology that they discovered, that they uncovered, anti-gravity maybe, or other technologies. In fact, we have a guy named Hayden who's here who wants to talk about the anti-gravity tech, and he's standing out in the crowd. Go ahead and tell us what you're doing.
Hi, my name's Aiden Schaefer. I'm from Taos, New Mexico.
earned a business degree from UNM in Albuquerque and started watching the skies. And after a while, you just start seeing glowing dots up in the air over the nuclear weapons lab. Recently, within the last year and a half, I became heavily involved with the Alternative Propulsion Engineering Conference, or APEC for short. We have Mark Sokol, Jeremy Reese, Tim Ventura. We're kind of the core group right now. We've been pulling in greats like Mark McCandlish and many others to talk about the nuts and bolts of flying saucers and the physics of field effect propulsion. For the last month, I was in Hawthorne, New Jersey, working with Mark and building a clean room and working on solid-state energy generation, the real simple physics that's been kind of kept quiet, but it's called a magnon. We're pretty sure that's part of the physics of how flying saucers fly, is creating magnons on the surface of the craft. It's real simple. Electron, magnon, photon. But we're, like I said, our main website is altpropulsion.com. We're a bi-weekly engineering conference. You can find us at that website or on YouTube with our Alien Scientists YouTuber channel. And then we're going to be representing at the first Silicon Valley Secret Space Program Business Development Conference here in September.
So with all that knowledge that you have and all those people you're working with, do you have an opinion on the recent Tic Tac reports from the Navy?
Probably the tall whites. The vehicle, it's obviously a type of field effect propulsion. Actually, with the female pilot, I forget her name, but we had a one-year anniversary at the APEC and had a special cake, and she really liked it on Twitter. But definitely a real vehicle. Recently on UFO Twitter, there was pictures of a Tic Tac shaped vehicle found on Google Earth near Catalina Island. So I don't know much. I mean, I've talked with a couple people about it, but I've focused more on, you know, the glowing disks and circular objects instead of ellipsoids.
Yeah, because I think people really want to know. I mean, from Roswell till now, they really want to know about this type of technology. They want to know if we're capable of having these craft and that perhaps they could be unknowns from either China or Russia. But they tend to trail off when they start talking about otherworldly objects. And that's the thing that's most frustrating about this, is because we know going back to the Cold War that this technology was being tested, or even before the Cold War, by the Germans. We know the Germans were testing. We know the Russians were testing it. The Vril Society was doing it. And then what? They take German scientists and they bring them over here. The Germans also go to Russia.
Operation Paperclip.
Yeah, they go to Canada. We got the Avro companies. We got Boeing. We got Martin Marietta. We got all these companies that are racing to hide a lot of what was discovered at Roswell, I believe. And they've been working on it now for 75 years. And the problem I'm having, and I'm going to talk with Don about this later on in the show, the problem I'm having is that what makes this so special that the military does not have to get evals or psychological evals when they talk about UFOs, but back when the 509th had high clearance and they were loading bombs on the Enola Gay, what makes them less capable of identifying a weather balloon from a flying saucer? That's the thing that bothers me.
Yeah. From my experience with actually seeing vehicles, you see it and I know we're live. You get a WTF moment. You know, it's like in Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy when Ford Prefect is talking to the bartender and he's like, he gives them that look and you know they're not from Earth.
Yeah.
So that's the stuff that I've seen. Maybe it's in the secret space program, if that really is true.
Right.
But for sure, I know there's life not from Earth that's been watching us for millennia. It's in the Bible.
Right.
It's in paintings. You know, we've never been alone.
And to add insult to injury, Don, did you hear about how, and maybe I'll ask you too, did you hear about how
They're setting up a special UFO UAP task force
with NASA
at Wright-Patterson.
Wright-Patterson, NASA.
And it's called Delta 18.
Right, right.
Like Hangar 18.
Like Hangar 18.
Did you hear about this?
No, yes, I haven't. Yes.
Yeah, Wright-Patterson is setting up, ironically, and I mean that with a big I, ironically, they're setting up this intelligence operations deal, which is an adjunct to what the Pentagon's doing. It's adjunct to what NASA is. NASA's now doing it, too. They're all looking after UAPs and UFOs, but having it done at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base and having it called Delta 18, again, is a huge slap in the face.
That's why we're calling it Project Blue Book 2.
Is that what it is?
Because it's going to be another PR front. In other words, that's why even with the congressional hearings a month ago, that right. the onus now is on Congress that if they were to exercise their immunity power
right.
and provide, you know, a forum for whistleblowers,
yeah.
you know, military, commercial pilots, radar operators, SAC-based Strategic Air Command officers to finally testify under oath, it would open this wide, you know, to the point right. that they'd never be able to put that genie back in the bottle.
Right.
So we will see. But as I said even before the hearings, the Pentagon never sends anyone up the Capitol Hill who may accidentally tell the truth.
Right. Yeah, I it's another way to control the narrative. And Aiden, yes. I'm sure the work that you do hopefully will be seen and we can reveal
it's all
once and for
source.
All. You know, our, once and for all we can say, hey, look, we've got the tech. Where did the tech come from? We do have the ability to mimic the tech and reverse engineer the tech.
We're getting close. Metamaterials is a hot word for it, a hot topic. Look at the alien scientist on YouTube and his Twitter channel.
All right.
He's got 15 plus years of digging through this. So, but
anyway, I'm sorry. My wife just stepped in. I've been distracted. You know how that goes.
Yes. Yeah. She's very important.
She is very important. Well, Aiden, thank you so much for your time. And Donald, we're going to come back in the next hour.
Altpropulsion.com.
Yes. Yes. Thank you so much. And we will be back with more. We're right in front of the Roswell Alien Museum tonight on Ground Zero. We're coming to you live. We'll be back with more with Donald R. Schmidt right here on Ground Zero. Don't go away.
It's that time of the year again. Pollen in the air, smoke in the air from all the fires. Well, you can purify the air in your home and get healthy, clean, fresh-smelling air. Eliminate odors, kill mold, mildew, and bacteria and viruses. You do it with the Eden Pure Thunderstorm Air Purifier. It uses oxy technology that naturally sends out O3 molecules into the air, which seek out odors and air pollutants in your home and destroys them. It doesn't mask or cover up bad odors and pollutants. It eliminates them. It's called the Thunderstorm because it purifies the air in your home and provides you with pure, fresh air just like after a thunderstorm. Right now, you can save $200 on an Eden Pure Thunderstorm 3-pack for whole home protection. You'll get 3 units for under $200. That's a fraction of the cost compared to other air purifiers can go for over $600. Put one in your basement, bedroom, family room, kitchen, or anywhere you need a clean, fresh air place. This is a special offer, and you're getting 3 units for under $200. Go to EdenPureDeals.com and put in discount code Clyde3 to save $200. That's EdenPureDeals.com, discount code Clyde3. Shipping is free.
I'm Andrew Saul, Commissioner of Social Security. I'm here to warn you about telephone scammers pretending to be government employees. Some of these scammers may say threatening things like you will be arrested if you don't make payments or provide personal information. Do not fall for these tricks. These calls are not from us. Real Social Security employees will never threaten you for information or money. If you receive a call like this, hang up. Never give the caller your personal information, like your Social Security number or bank account, or send money in any form, cash, gift cards, wire transfers, or prepaid debit cards. Report the call to our law enforcement arm, the Office of the Inspector General, at oig.ssa.gov. Share this information with your friends and family.
News this hour from townhall.com. I'm Tayshia Stevens. Ketanji Brown Jackson is sworn into the Supreme Court. Correspondent Jessica Gresko reports.
This is the first time that the Supreme Court has not been made up of a majority of white men. So, of course, there are now two black justices on the court, Justice Jackson and Justice Clarence Thomas, who is the longest serving justice on the court. And, of course, now there are four women on the court for the first time ever.
Four have died following a police chase in South Texas that involved human smugglers. Police say an SUV filled with illegal immigrants crashed into the back of a parked 18-wheeler while trying to escape from law enforcement. Two others are in critical condition. Police say the chase started on the border in Laredo, Texas. A U.S. official says the tractor trailer at the center of a disastrous human smuggling attempt that left 53 people dead passed through an inland U.S. Border Patrol checkpoint on I-35 northeast of Laredo. The Texas Department of Public Safety has announced new inland vehicle checkpoints. Texas Governor Greg Abbott says this week's tractor trailer tragedy may have been prevented with better funding from Border Patrol.
As you all surely know, the truck passed through a border point checkpoint. It was not inspected. It was not inspected because the Border Patrol does not have the resources to be able to inspect all of the trucks. And as a result, the Border Patrol did not have the capability of saving those lives.
The U.S. National Hurricane Center says a storm that pummeled the southern Caribbean and the northern shoulder of South America with rain is expected to hit Central America as a tropical storm over the weekend and eventually develop into a hurricane over the Pacific. More on these stories at townhall.com. I'm Tayshia Stevens.
If you have certain chronic conditions, such as heart disease,
asthma,
diabetes, and you're 19 years of age or older, 52,
36,
42. You may be at increased risk for pneumococcal pneumonia. Ask your doctor or pharmacist about getting vaccinated with Prevnar 20, pneumococcal 20-valent conjugate vaccine, a Pfizer vaccine that can help protect against pneumococcal pneumonia in just one dose. Prevnar 20 is approved for adults to help prevent infections from 20 strains of the bacteria that cause pneumococcal pneumonia. Continued approval may depend on a supportive study. Don't get Prevnar 20 if you've had a severe allergic reaction to the vaccine or its ingredients. Adults with weakened immune systems may have a lower response to the vaccine. The most commonly reported side effect was pain at the injection site. For additional common side effects and full prescribing information, please call 1-855-213-2138 or visit Prevnar20.com.
I'm going to ask my doctor
about getting vaccinated
with Prevnar 20.
A sale puts Ben and Jerry's ice cream back in the West Bank. Kinda.
Unilever reached a new business arrangement in Israel, effectively ending the ice cream maker's policy of not selling its product in annexed East Jerusalem and the occupied West Bank. Israel hailed the move as a victory against the Palestinian-led boycott, divestment, and sanctions movement, which aims to bring economic pressure to bear on Israel over its military occupation of lands the Palestinians want for a future state. Unilever, which owns Ben & Jerry's, sold its business interest in Israel to a local company that will sell the product throughout Israel and the West Bank. Rhonda Rockster reporting.
Americans give President Biden poor grades on controlling crime, the latest Rasmussen poll. Many expect crime to be a major issue in the November midterm elections, and the latest poll shows that does not bode well for the president and his party. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Tayshia Stevens. Israel's parliament dissolves itself to set up another election.
The Knesset has voted to dissolve itself, marking the end of a year-old experimental coalition government and sending the country to the polls on November 1 for the fifth time in less than 4 years. Following the vote, Yair Lapid, Israel's foreign minister and architect of the outgoing coalition government, embraced Naftali Bennett, Israel's shortest-serving prime minister, before they swapped chairs. The government has collapsed just over a year after it was formed in a historic move that saw longtime leader Benjamin Netanyahu ousted after 12 years in power by a coalition of ideologically diverse parties, the first to include an Arab faction. I'm Charles de Ledesma.
More on these stories at townhall.com. I'm Tayshia Stevens.
You have 5 seconds. 5, 3, 2, 1.
Oh my God, you guys! Another space shuttle exploded!
Well, there's only one thing to do. Let's paint.
Painting the wall. To get through tough times. When shuttles blow up, it's not always an accident.
What do you mean, not an accident? Who is this guy singing?
And who am I, a conspiracy fly? Did you know NASA means deceive in Hebrew?
I did not.
The Denver Airport was built by the Illuminati.
Peter, shoo that fly out of here.
I will as soon as I find out if he has a band from the Apple Store podcast I can listen to.
I do. It's flyonthewall.buzz/truth. First, reconfigure your DNS server. Then download a VPN and get the Tor browser.
Ground zero.
The loudspeaker spoke up and said,
"We
win." The loudspeaker spoke up and said,
"We win."
The loudspeaker spoke up and said, "Give up.
Give up.
Give up.
I'm Clyde Lewis, and this is Ground Zero. Coming to you live tonight from downtown Roswell, New Mexico, in front of the Roswell Alien Museum. We're brought to you by KSVP and Artesia, KEND in Roswell, and we're glad to be here. Gene, thank you so much for having us tonight. Gene Dow. Thank you, Ron Patton. Thank you, Wes Scottko, for being back home in Portland. We're going to get a t-shirt for you or something. You know, and a mug. We'll get him a mug. Something. He's probably flipping me off right now as we're talking. Anyway, So Don Schmidt with us on Ground Zero, and always a pleasure having him on the show, especially when we're in Roswell.
Pleasure's mine.
We've had you on even when we're not in Roswell, so that's a good
thing,
too.
Absolutely, many a time. Yes.
So, okay, we're talking about the memo, and I know that we took some time to talk about this this new technology, and that's great. But I want to get into the core here, because there was another technician who worked for the University of Manchester.
Yes.
His name was Neil Morris.
Yes.
And he went in and did another interpretation. But what he did is he was actually he was doing best guess at some other letters and other things. And I wanted to read what I got from the documents, and I want to get your opinion on this. First, Airy were as, and several, let's see, RESCV-1 victims of the wreck convey onto at Fort Worth, Texas, SSMI, the else unused T&E, let's see here, a lot of it is, so OT crashed power and Site 1 remote. Database told for we use our story, put the weather balloons, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, and then Denver. This is even more jumbled than the other. What are your thoughts on this?
It's not considered one of the more reliable interpretations. I think David Rudiak's is considered by far for just the amount of time, the amount of years, and that is his profession as an optometrician. In other words, that he specializes in photo interpretation.
Right.
And it's a type of devotion to coming in with a non-preconceived theory as to how something is going to read or what images you're finally going to discern and accept as being legitimate, as opposed to, you see, in Rudiak's case, he wasn't into Roswell before all this. And I think so many of the others were already into UFOs. And that's another problem I have, that when you have like the History Channel or Discovery Channel, and they hire someone to do a quick interpretation using their state-of-the-art equipment.
Right.
They'll spend all of maybe a few hours, and just like that, this is my, you know, professional opinion.
Yeah.
And end of story. Well, Rudiak has spent years. And you also, again, you have to understand, as I said earlier, the military jargon and how a telex would be worded. And again, there are only 26 possible letter combinations that then would make coherent words,
right,
which then become coherent sentences.
Well, Rudiak, even, like you say, he wasn't into Roswell. But Rudiak's final interpretation kind of made it even clearer when it said, and this is, I'm reading here, "Officer, July 4th, the victims of the wreck you forwarded to the EAM at Fort Worth, Texas. 5 p.m., the disc they will ship or swap for A38th arrived or 58th Bomber Squadron. Assist access offices to Roswell." As for the 54th, said it was mistaken meeting weather balloon, or as a story and said news clip that dirt is out about the weather balloons, which, of course, dirt cover crews, Ramey.
Right, right. And the information we had even prior to any interpretation of the memo is that General Roger Ramey's main contact in Washington at the Pentagon at that time was General Hoyt Vandenberg, who was Chief of Staff of the Air Force. And the fact that on the other side of this telex, it, according to Rudiak, he feels it reads Vandenberg. So that the telex is from Ramey. It's not to Ramey. Ramey's providing, you know, this information to Washington.
Right.
And one of the other things, aside from the memo itself, as I had originally described, there are four shots with Ramey, either by himself, two alone, and then two more with his chief of staff, Colonel DeBose. Three of the shots are of the backside of the blank paper, the telex. That it's only the one. So in other words, he either caught himself and then flipped it the other way as it's being photographed.
Right.
And in the shots specifically holding the memo, he's got a bad thumb gash in his thumbnail. And for an officer, that's unprofessional, unheard of.
Right.
The idea that he didn't even have time to file down that nail or trim that nail. He's also wearing his cap and his tie in his own office, which also demonstrates how quickly that all came together. And so it all then suggests that for those, well, he certainly wouldn't have, you know, allowed a telex or any type of memo to be in eyeshot of a camera lens if he actually knew that it was contrary to their balloon explanation. But again, it came together based on appearance and based on that thumbnail gash quickly. And as a result, I think he got caught just in that one picture. And then he flipped the paper to the backside for the next three.
So from the memo, we can conclude that the wreckage and the bodies were sent to Wright Patt. Then they were transferred to Texas, right?
Well,
I'm trying to get the
timeline
know, here.
I know. Yeah. Or that via Fort Worth, because it's going up the chain of command. And that General Roger Ramey was commander of the 8th Air Force, which oversaw the 509th bomb wing. So the base commander at Roswell, Colonel William Blanchard, his boss was General Roger Ramey.
Okay. See, this is why this memo is so amazing, is we're unraveling the true story of Roswell with Donald Schmidt right here on Ground Zero. Back with more. We're live in Roswell. Don't go away.
Hey guys, I'm so excited to tell you about something that's really helping me, and I think it's going to help you too. Biotech Research has announced that it has a new supplement called Brain Peak 9. Now, Brain Peak 9 contains the 9 nutrients that may help support brain function of memory, concentration, recall, and improved focus. Customers are raving about Brain Peak 9. Francis D. says, it works very well for me and helps support my memory. Joe O. says, started taking it because my memory is horrible. It seemed to correct that. And Heather R. says, helps me focus and stay on task. That's what it does to me. I use it. Other memory supplements can cost as high as $129 for a 60-day supply. But right now, for a limited time, you can use discount code Clyde and you'll get a 60-day supply for just $49. There's no better time than right now to see what others have been raving about. Help improve your brain function. Go to brainpeak9.com and enter the discount code Clyde. That's brainpeak9.com. Discount code Clyde.
Want to kill bugs like the pros do? Now you can with Maggie's Farm. Created by pest control professionals, Maggie's Farm plant and mineral-based products provide amazingly effective insect control. Ants, spiders, flies, mosquitoes, you name it, we kill it. All of our plant-based products are safe to use around children and pets and won't leave behind a messy, oily residue like some other products. Maggie's Farm. Lethal to bugs. Easy on the planet. Look for Maggie's Farm at your favorite retail store or at maggiesfarmproducts.com.
You know what makes a great gift? A comfortable pillow, elegant Giza Dreams bed sheets, maybe some new slippers, sleepwear. It's all there at MyPillow.com. MyPillow.com. Let me say it again. MyPillow.com/Ken. Plus, Mike Lindell is a great American comeback success story. MyPillow.com. Buy someone you care about a great gift or treat yourself. MyPillow.com/Ken.
Don't do what I did and run out. If it's working, don't quit. Why undo all the good that's been accomplished?
You've got to feed them right for life.
Dynavite is nutrition.
If I ever took Roy off of Dynavite.
No.
When I get to about 3/4.
When I get down to the bottom of my box of Dynavite.
Oh, no. I've got a couple more scoops.
It's time to place my order. Dynavite.com.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
Order a 90-day supply of Dynavite for your dog this week.
We'll send you a bottle of NomoFlea free.
NomoFlea flea spray kills fleas safely with no poison.
Because it's a polypeptide protein molecule made from
vegetable oil.
Try NomoFlea
free this week at Dynavite.com.
Just feed your dog right. Use Dynavite.
Dynavite for life.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
Dinovite .com.
If your car's no longer covered by a manufacturer's warranty, repairing it can break the bank.
Rebuild, replace transmission, $3,200. Anti-lock brake system, $1,000. Rebuild, replace engine, $2,400.
The truth is, once your warranty runs out, it's all on you. Every last cent. A vehicle service contract just makes sense. And a vehicle service contract from Toco Warranty makes the most sense. Many other companies hit you with a large down payment. With Toco, there's no down payment. And with Toco, you can pay as you go with affordable payments. Don't waste another minute. Pick up the phone and call Toco right now to start saving big money on expensive covered auto repairs. Prices vary by vehicle. The monthly price for most plans, about the cost of a tank of gas per month. Get your free quote now. Call Toco at 800-897-9537. That's 800.
See the ground zero.
That's okay.
We are live.
And loud.
And loud. Every motorcycle and their dog is out tonight. But we still are getting down to the bottom of this memo. You were saying, we were talking earlier, actually during the break, we were talking about what's next.
Right, right.
And, of course, this is going to eliminate all doubt or all reality here if we go with one more thing. What would that be?
Well, that would be AI, artificial intelligence. Same thing that we've done as far as with voice analysis, which in the past would have been psychological stress evaluation. Still open to human interpretation. But here we would allow the computer to actually make an unbiased assessment of everything that would be programmed. So in other words, it'd be actually creating a program designed to just essentially read government documents, government telex.
It could pretty much, I think, estimate or somehow figure out how the sentence structure would be and probably fill in the blanks.
Precisely.
For you.
Based on everything, all the information that you would download, and as a result, and I'd like to believe that we could get a consensus between those of us who may be considered pro-Roswell in that regard and those who are skeptics. The idea that we will finally, agree to accept that whatever AI would determine.
Yeah, I think that what we need, and it's difficult to get this because, again, you and I both know that we need to somehow get into the hearts and the minds of the young to keep the story going. And we need to, I think, get a little perspective when we're looking at the events and how they happened and what transpired. I think that, again, sometimes the mythology, sometimes the legend gets in the way of the truth.
Yes, yes, yes.
And it's obvious to me that's the case when I listen to newscasts and they're talking about Roswell and then they talk about Area 51 in the same sentence.
I know.
And it's because they don't
do
their homework. There's no connection whatsoever. They don't do their homework. So immediately, it's all some mishmash of the X-Files and something else. And it's never the facts. And it's always, something crashed, and it was a weather balloon, and blah, 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 blah. But they don't know about these intricate investigations into the memo that General Ramey had or the telex that General Ramey was sending out to say, yeah, there are victims in this crash. Yes, we are doing all we can to change the story so nobody knows that this happened. And people, I don't think, understand the history where, it's like I said, whatever happened was big enough to have the Air Force and the Army separate.
Correct.
It was big enough for Truman to start
the National Security Apparatus
with the NSA and the CIA.
Within days after Roswell.
And you look at what's happening now,
right,
75 years later, and you see what? We got a report of a Muamua.
Right.
We got a report right after Oumuamua that our Navy was being buzzed by Tic Tacs.
Right.
The New York Times decides to run the story. Then we have a bunch of military guys coming forward, just like Roswell.
Correct.
President Trump says we need a Space Force.
That's correct.
So we add another branch to the military.
Right.
And then we create another national security apparatus from the Pentagon.
That's correct.
It has offices and Congress and others getting down to the bottom of the UFO story.
We're all looking into it for the first time.
Yeah, and then we have Wright-Patterson Air Force Base in the news again.
Yes.
Saying that they are going to have another study group, and NASA, of course, space group. Then they're all combining forces to find out the truth. But then we forget about the Cold War stories of Roswell.
Precisely.
What are your thoughts on that?
Well, first of all, as the old saying, we have to know where we've been to know where we are. And the fact that most people are far from students of history.
Right.
And that would include many of our colleagues, many of the people that are now serving as spokespeople on this subject.
Exactly.
And they don't know the history.
No.
They don't know. They don't remember how often this carrot has been dangled, you know, in front of us, and how often it's been reeled back.
Right.
I'm specifically concerned about the fact that they are limiting the scope of their acknowledgement of the phenomena back to 2004.
Yes.
And as a result, their fallback can be Russia, China, and certainly Space Force. Just imagine if this technology that they're acknowledging as being state-of-the-art, sophisticated beyond anything we have, is now the new established Space Force. And the message that would send to Russia and China, it would be, oh my God, it's like now we're in trouble.
Well, you heard that China, the Department of Truth, or Department of Ministry, Science Ministry, said that they picked up a signal from the Kepler system.
Right, right, right.
And immediately they said, no, didn't happen. That, I think, is their Roswell.
Yes, yes, it may indeed be. And I've been to China on three separate occasions.
Yeah.
And I have colleagues that, well, we need to establish an open door policy with China regarding UFOs. And it's like, no, you're talking about the government.
Right.
Because you can count the number of investigators on two fingers in China.
Right.
And the point being that because of the communism, because of the suppression and the lack of government disclosure on any topic.
Right.
It's all government contained, all government controlled.
I talked with Xiao Ma, who is a Chinese national, who talked about what happened with the latest Chinese signal thing. And she said, it's a lie that they're telling you it was a microwave oven or it was
right.
It was a phone, because they moved those people out of that area.
There isn't that interesting?
No, cell phone use or microwave use for miles.
Unbelievable.
Because they didn't want any interference.
Mm-hmm,
so
mm-hmm.
This whole cover story of it being a microwave or something is a lie.
Shades of the radio transmissions back from the moon landings, the idea that beyond a 7-second delay that you normally would have, that there was a total blackout, a total cutout as far as any... And then the ham radio operators were picking up other, you know, communications.
Yeah, it's like, you know, they can't pull this off forever. And people, you know, they don't tell you the whole story. And so immediately, and that's why I was going to run by you, and I think we've talked about this before, maybe not. But it's always been, and even more now than it was back when we first talked to you and I. Because we were both saying, okay, how is it that these men that could put the bombs on the planes, have security clearances and all that, not know the difference between a weather balloon and whatever they found at Roswell? How is it that we take these men who were soldiers, who fought the war effort, and we basically make them out to be morons?
Precisely.
And then 75 years later, the military men who are on, you know, all these warships, seeing the Tic Tacs, everything's changed now. We need to go back and give an apology to these men.
And the point being that the 509th Bomb Wing, stationed here in Roswell in 1947, they were the elite within the military at this time. It was a composite unit where they selected the best officers, the best pilots, crew, doctors, nurses. If you swept a broom on that base back in 1947, it's because you were the best sweeper in the entire U.S. military. You all had a top security clearance for the newly deployed atomic bomb. And you're the only ones who are in that position in the world at that time. And on top of it, in conjunction with their daily bomb drop exercises, they were flying their B-29s all around Roswell. There were emergency runways all around the city at that time if they had to come down.
Right.
They were using sand barrels, the equivalent of the actual bomb casings. But nonetheless, they were launching these very balloons every day just to the north of here atop that bank building.
Right.
Twice a day in conjunction with those bomb drops. Nobody was more knowledgeable of those balloons at that time than the personnel here at Roswell. And where did the weather balloon come from in the General Ramey weather balloon press conference? Here from Roswell. When we asked then Brigadier General Thomas DeBose, who was Ramey's chief of staff, who was pictured in two of the shots, First of all, he signed a sworn affidavit stating that the balloon was a hoax. And then he added, we were the ones who switched the material for the balloon. And then when I asked him, where did the balloon come from? Well, it sure didn't come from here because we weren't launching them. It came from Roswell.
Amazing. Don Schmidt with us tonight. This is important evidence that something very important happened at Roswell. You can make your determinations. You can call us at 503-225-0860. If you have a comment, call us right now. 503-225-0860. We'll be back.
Where is my mind? Where is my mind? Where is my mind? Way out in the waters, you're swimming.
With SRN News, I'm Tayshia Stevens. Ketanji Brown Jackson sworn into the Supreme Court. The 51-year-old is the court's 116th justice, replacing Justice Stephen Breyer, whose retirement took effect at noon. Jackson raised eyebrows during confirmation proceedings when she said she cannot give a definition of the word woman because she said she is not a biologist. Texas Attorney General Ken Paxton says that he wants the Supreme Court justices to issue an immediate stay, this after a temporary restraining order is placed on Texas' abortion ban. The state's trigger law is scheduled to go into effect in a few weeks. A Texas yoga instructor accused of killing a professional cyclist is under arrest in Central America. U.S. Marshals say Caitlin Armstrong was captured in Costa Rica. And China's president officiates the swearing-in ceremony of Hong Kong's new leader, John Lee. This is the city Mark's 25 years of return to communist rule. This is SRN News.
We tried Dynavite Nutritional Supplement, and after a couple of weeks, we noticed a big difference. Our little Gizmo's coat was shinier, and there was a lot less scratching and shedding.
My dog smelled and scratched constantly. We bathed and sprayed her, took her to the vet, but no results. Now, a little Dynavite in her food helps Bella keep her beautiful coat with no scratching or smell.
Happier, healthier with every bite. Over a million pets helped with Dynavite.
New message.
What up, what up? It's Heather's cousin. You dated her in college, or maybe you were just in the same class. Anyway, I heard you bought a boat, my man. Let's hit the water. Oh, and Heather told me you always liked snacks and stuff, so I could totally bring some chips.
When you get a boat, you also get new friends. Make sure Progressive's one of them. And get coverage today for as little as $100 a year.
Hey, also, I'm a little short on cash, so can you cover the chips? Thanks. I can see why Heather liked you.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Annual premium for basic liability policy not available in all states.
Beak. Lowering your high blood pressure could save you from a heart attack or stroke. If you've stopped your treatment plan, restart it, or talk to your doctor about creating one that works better for you. Start taking the right steps at manageyourbp.org.
It's a new life, but I'm going to make it better. I'll come back. Ask your doctor, check your blood pressure.
Brought to you by the American Heart Association, American Medical Association, and the Ad Council.
Uh-oh, Brad's buzzed.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's starting with the woots. And now a speech.
I just want to say that friendship is about heart. Heart and brain. Who's with me?
Good thing is, he knows when he's buzzed.
And my brain is saying, when it's time to go home, somebody call me a ride.
Love that guy.
Me too.
Know your buzzed warning signs? Call for a ride when it's time to go home. Buzz driving is drunk driving. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Did you know that more than half our household energy costs go to heating and cooling? Energy efficiency isn't just good for the environment. It means lower utility bills, too. One way to reduce your energy waste is a home energy assessment. Your utility company can help. Or you can learn how to do it yourself at energysavers.gov. That's energysavers.gov. You'll learn to look for air leaks around windows and doors, check ducts for holes, and improve your insulation. Another time to cut energy costs is when you shop for a new appliance. Look for the Energy Star logo and read the Energy Guide label. And there are day-to-day things you can do. Lower your thermostat in winter and raise it in the summer.
Close fireplace dampers when they're not in.
So what exactly did the press release say?
Very simple, to the effect that we had in our possession a flying saucer. It was found on our ranch up north of Roswell. It was being flown to General Ramey's office, that being the next higher command. That was the Elite Air Force. And that would be...
They all show the same thing, a bright light with what appears to be a sort of blue-green tail. People from Menifee to Oxnard to L.A., Catalina Island, even down to San Diego, all reported the same thing.
The story that I put out was very simple. It was what Colonel Blanchard said he wanted put into a press release. When the colonel tells the first lieutenant almost verbatim what he wants in a press release, guess what he gets? You don't argue with him and say, oh, I think it would sound better if we said it this way or the next way. The answer to all is yes, sir.
So what exactly did the press release say?
In essence, it was very simple, to the effect that we had in our possession a flying saucer.
I'm Clyde Lewis. You are listening to Ground Zero. We are live tonight from the Roswell Alien Museum. The number to call tonight, 503-225-0860. That's 503-225-0860. We need to try the remote system on the phone, so if you want to call in, we'd love to hear from you. 503-225-0860. There is little doubt that something fell out of the sky and it was unknown here in Roswell. The authorities knew it. Official actions had to be taken. And this action led to the separation of the Army and the Air Force, the creation of the CIA. President Truman signed the National Securities Act, which basically established a single Department of Defense. Many skeptics claim that all testimony about Roswell is simply an overreaction to a mundane happening, yet we see the actions taken by a government scrambling for answers to a complex event, an event that has been kept secret for 75 years. And it's evident that the United States government and the paramilitary are lying about what really happened in the New Mexican prairie, and that they have smeared the reputations of honest and dedicated men who served the country during World War II. No veteran or serviceman who fought and served our country should be treated this way. And I said the same thing for the other military men that were talking about the Tic Tacs. But then, of course, they're being heard now. But many were put down, said that they were seeing things, Jesse Marcel and others. And there are many questions about Roswell that seem to go unanswered by the military. While the Roswell crash had produced very little evidence of extraterrestrial origins, it needs to be stated that the military treated the wreckage and the occupants differently. All the witnesses say it was definitely not a weather balloon. This cargo was special, and many actions by personnel need to be evaluated. So, Donald Schmidt, you're my guest tonight on Ground Zero. Thank you for being here. It's great to have you here. Why was there a need for secrecy when something as simple as a weather balloon crashed at Roswell?
Well, first of all, you're talking about the beginning of the Cold War. And because of the atomic bomb, I find it amusing that every time I lecture on college campus and I pose the question if the faculty are present, where was the first atomic bomb detonated? And how many of them? Well, of course, Japan.
Yeah.
And when you tell them, it was just 2 hours west of Roswell, of all places. What was amusing at first, when we would make our trips down here to New Mexico to initiate the investigation, you'd listen to the old-timers talk about how that very next morning after that detonation in July of 1945, that the next morning the streets, the sidewalks, their cars are all covered in this gray ash. And they had no idea. And they're sweeping it off with their bare hands and blowing it off of their windshields and things, and they had no idea that it was radioactive fallout.
Right.
So right there was an example of, yeah, there's our government being totally upfront and telling us the truth. Well, this was right just 2 years before, and it happened to be the same city that then 2 years later, they put out the press release that they've captured a flying saucer. And within 5 hours, it's explained away, not here in Roswell, but as we were describing at the very beginning of the program, at a press conference in Fort Worth, where they trotted out a weather balloon, a very common off-the-shelf balloon that a five-year-old child would have recognized, and the thought that the very people with their fingers on the atomic bomb wouldn't have recognized it for what it was. Sorry, you know, that's an insult to everyone.
Why is it that if the balloon was so damn top secret, how is it that it could be flashed on every newspaper in the
world? Precisely.
That's the thing that doesn't make any sense.
And that they would have a press conference actually displaying it.
Yeah, look, this is a top secret balloon, everybody. Yeah. Look at this.
So, and then
Doesn't make any sense.
The fallback is that, well, it was the project that was top secret. Okay, fine. But even the project still is comprised of very common, recognizable materials that, once again, even a child would have recognized. And as we described earlier, the fact that they were launching those very balloons in conjunction with bomb drop exercises.
Right.
Nothing, you know, I'm sorry, to this day, is going to ever convince me that this had anything to do with a balloon of any sort.
Here's another thing. If the balloon was so important,
right,
if it was so top secret, if it was a top secret military exercise, then why did a farmer have to notify them of the crash?
Precisely. Precisely.
Because if they are tracking their top secret balloons, then they would have known it went down.
Exactly, Clyde.
At the Foster Ranch.
I couldn't agree more. As I often point out, this is at the time was a 4th of July holiday weekend. Most of the base personnel were home on leave with their families. And the fact that when the rancher came into town, he first of all doesn't go to the military. He goes to the courthouse. He goes to the sheriff.
Yeah.
So it's the sheriff, George Wilcox, who then notifies the base. And who should pick up the phone but the very head of intelligence, Major Jesse Marcel. Well, he retrieves some of the wreckage from the courthouse, takes it back to the base, and it's important enough on a holiday weekend that he notifies the base commander. Yeah. Like, what do we have here? We don't recognize this. What are we talking about? And then Blanchard doesn't just send a couple of enlisted men, a couple of grunts to check it out, humor the rancher, you know, have some fun. Yeah. No, he sends out Marcel, the head of intelligence, and the head of counterintelligence, Captain Sheridan Cabot, suggesting that he was the expert on foreign materials and that they needed his input in regards to that as well.
Right. I mean, if they were tracking this Mogul balloon, the phone call would have been, what has crashed? And
exactly.
He'd say, we're tracking these balloons. It got loose, and so no problem.
But and
no,
for those of
it
us...
It was a flying disc. It was reported as a flying disc.
Right.
They didn't know what it was, and they had the head of intelligence go in and try and decipher.
And for those of us who have been out to that very location hundreds of times as we've done archaeological work and we're still searching for physical proof, that type of thing, to have flown over the area in small planes and helicopters numerous times. Once you are airborne, this is wide open high desert.
Right.
Once you are airborne, you can see for 50 miles. The idea that if there would have been any effort to recover a secret balloon of any sort or any other secret test, they would have found it before the rancher even did.
And another thing, too, is if it was one of ours, okay, but
right.
It was a military aircraft that crashed, wouldn't the 509th Bombing Group, who are used to seeing secret I guess, planes or whatever, wouldn't they know what they were dealing with?
Of course.
I mean, I was always of the opinion that they had clearances, that they all had intelligence
they
clearances.
They all had top security clearance because of the atomic bomb.
And we would be on alert because of the Soviet Union.
Right.
So if the Soviet Union would have launched something against Roswell or against Corona or wherever, then they would be aware of it.
Absolutely.
It doesn't make any sense.
No, it doesn't. And as UFOs were in the news at that time, called flying saucers.
Right.
They were observant. They were tracking. And the point is the personnel at the base here in Roswell were looking skyward. They were anticipating having sightings at any time.
Yeah, yeah. We're going to be back. I think I'm hearing the music. Things are loud right now. But we're going to be back with Don Schmidt right here on Ground Zero. We're live in Roswell. We'll be back. It's that time of the year again. Pollen in the air, smoke in the air from all the fires. Well, you can purify the air in your home and get healthy, clean, fresh-smelling air. Eliminate odors, kill mold, mildew, and bacteria and viruses. You do it with the Eden Pure Thunderstorm Air Purifier. It uses oxy technology that naturally sends out O3 molecules into the air, which seek out odors and air pollutants in your home and destroys them. It doesn't mask or cover up bad odors and pollutants. It eliminates them. It's called the Thunderstorm because it purifies the air in your home and provides you with pure, fresh air just like after a thunderstorm. Right now, you can save $200 on an Eden Pure Thunderstorm 3-pack protection. You'll get 3 units for under $200. That's a fraction of the cost compared to other air purifiers. It can go for over $600. Put one in your basement, bedroom, family room, kitchen, or anywhere you need a clean, fresh air place. This is a special offer, and you're getting 3 units for under $200. Go to EdenPureDeals.com and put in discount code Clyde3 to save $200. That's EdenPureDeals.com, discount code Clyde3. Shipping is free.
Let's see, if something costs less, but people are happier with it, that sounds like something to look into, and that's MediShare. Maybe you've heard switching to MediShare to pay for healthcare can save the typical family $500 a month, and that's huge, but it's also true that people are way more satisfied after making the switch, too. The customer satisfaction rate for MediShare is double that of the typical health insurance plan. Double. MediShare works. It's been around for more than a quarter century, and members have shared more than $3 billion of each other's bills. People love having telehealth and a huge nationwide PPO network. So, yeah, you can save a ton and like it better. Imagine being happy with how you're taking care of your health care. So if you're self-employed or part of the gig economy, or you just want a plan you're happy with, you can call right now and get a price within 2 minutes. A very, very smart use of 2 minutes. Here's the number you need. 855-SHARE-40. That's 855-SHARE-40. 855-SHARE-40.
Don't do what I did and run out. If it's working, don't quit. Why undo all the good that's been accomplished?
You've got to feed them right for life.
Dynavite is nutrition.
If I ever took Roy off of Dynavite.
No.
When I get to about 3/4.
When I get down to the bottom of my box of Dynavite.
Oh, no. I've got a couple more scoops.
It's time to place my order. Dynavite.com.
D-I-N-O-V-I-T-E .com.
859-428-1000.
Order a 90-day supply of Dynavite for your dog this week.
We'll send you a bottle of NomoFlea free.
NomoFlea flea spray kills fleas safely with no poison.
Because it's a polypeptide protein molecule made from
vegetable oil.
Try NomoFlea
free this week at Dynavite.com.
Just feed your dog right. Use Dynavite.
Dynavite for life.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
Dynovite .com.
If your car's no longer covered by a manufacturer's warranty, repairing it can break the bank. Rebuild, replace transmission, $3,200. Anti-lock brake system, $1,000. Rebuild, replace engine, $2,400. The truth is, once your warranty runs out, it's all on you. Every last cent. A vehicle service contract just makes sense. And a vehicle service contract from Toco Warranty makes the most sense. Many other companies hit you with a large down payment. With Toco, there's no down payment. And with Toco, you can pay as you go with affordable payments. Don't waste another minute. Pick up the phone and call Toco right now to start saving big money on expensive covered auto repairs. Prices vary by vehicle. The monthly price for most plans, about the cost of a tank of gas per month. Get your free quote now. Call Toco at 800-897-9537. That's 800.
We're back at the International UFO Museum and Research Center in Roswell, New Mexico. It's the 75th anniversary observance of the Roswell crash. I understand we have a caller from Nevada. We have James on the line. James, hi. You're on Ground Zero.
Yeah, thanks for taking my call. I wanted to bring up CERN technology, and I think on July 4th, they're going to do one of their experiments again. It actually uses more electricity than the whole United States uses in 1 year. And it's possibly going to open up a portal. And then things like Nimrod and other things that were banished by God years and years, many years ago, are going to be coming back. And they're going to convince the people that they're aliens. I want to know what you think about CERN technology and what they're doing with the head of Nimrod at the Vatican.
Well, we're going to do a show about CERN technology probably on the 5th because they are going to fire it up. CERN technology is a quark cannon. It's being fired They're slamming particles together. It has the power of a neutron star. And yes, it can open up portals, and it can bring in... In fact, Jordy Rose said that this could be the case. We're going to try and get down to the bottom of it and answer it probably after we get back from Roswell. So as far as my opinion, I don't know what they're going to be bringing through. Could be aliens, could be fourth-dimensional beings, could be anything. But what we need to concern ourselves with is whether or not the Higgs boson has been found and whether or not it's unstable. And if it is, it would explain a lot about why we're in the situation we're in right now.
You know, keeping in mind, even back at the time prior to the first detonation of the atomic bomb at Trinity site,
yeah,
that there was a concern that the blast may go upwards and open a hole right through the atmosphere.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, in fact, I think it was Enrico Fermi that had a bet saying that, I'm going to have a bet that when this thing goes off, it's going to create a whirlwind of fire so great that
right,
it's going to suck us into the universe.
Mm-hmm.
So,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, so, I mean, the nuclear bomb, excuse me, was just as bad as what they're doing at CERN. So we're going to talk about that probably coming up in the next few days. So I appreciate the call, James. In the audience tonight, we have Bonnie, who wanted to share with us a story, and it's an amazing story. So, Bonnie, you go right ahead and share it with us tonight.
Oh, okay. Hi.
Hi.
Well, my uncle was Lowell Randall. He raised my mother, and he maintained until his dying day that he saw those aliens, and it was just like Independence Day. The bodies were in formaldehyde, and he saw them, and he said that they weren't all dead. And he maintained this story until he died. He died when he was 96. And like I said, he raised my mom, and that he just maintained that to his dying day, that this is what happened. He worked at White Sands Missile Range and everything, and, you know, he just said that it was real.
You said earlier, I believe, something about Wernher von Braun.
He worked with Wernher von Braun when he was here. He worked with all of them that were involved in all of that, and worked with Dr. Goddard and everything.
Have you heard the latest that they say that maybe Einstein was here too when it all went down?
I was
reading about that today, but I have always wondered about whether or not Wernher von Braun was involved somehow with the Roswell situation, because we know about the Vril, we know about the Project Paperclip or Operation Paperclip.
I think he might have been, you know, because
he knew
all kinds of stuff, my uncle. He wasn't allowed to talk about a lot of it.
Right.
And we know that von Braun was here subsequently,
okay, right,
on two different occasions. But you had mentioned as far as right to his dying day. Would you say that, I mean, did he make any... as far as pronouncement, did he say anything up to the point that he was still lucid and able to speak?
Yes.
Right up to days before he passed. Did he say anything more about this?
He was 96. He said that, you know, he just maintained that to his dying day,
saw them. So you did at that point still.
Yes, and he's got it in his memoirs, too, that are supposed to be, my cousin has them and all the other information, you know, of all the stuff that but like I said, he wasn't allowed to talk about a lot of it because those people were threatened.
So he wrote memoirs.
Yes.
How far back did they date?
Well, all the way back into the 1950s or so, when all this in the 40s and everything, because he worked at White Sands Missile Range and everything.
What's the soonest he mentions anything regarding observing the bodies, approximately?
What was the soonest that he... what was as soon as he mentioned witnessing the bodies? You remember?
In his memoirs.
I don't know, but he said that when it crashed, he knew all about it. Because my mother was living with them. She remembers him talking about it.
What would be especially interesting to me is that any mention of bodies would predate the first book on Roswell, which came out in 1980.
Hmm.
Where the skeptics would suggest that these people have been influenced by what they read in the book. So it's very crucial if you could at least check and see if there's any mention prior to 1980. That would be significant.
I always thought there was mentions before, and they never did call them. They didn't call them aliens. They said that they were just
bodies.
They
small
said
bodies.
Small bodies.
Little men.
Diminutive bodies or whatever is what they were saying. So
they were small.
Yeah.
Which was always something significant to us, the fact that they weren't calling them spacemen or calling them aliens, that they were describing them as best they could for the time. There was nothing in the Army field manual as far as crash recovery of a flying saucer, that type of thing. They weren't calling them even spaceships. They were describing what they saw.
It wasn't even saucer-shaped.
That's right.
It was. I've seen the ideas for the design, and it was nowhere near looking like a saucer.
No, that's correct.
It looked like it had like a sort of a streamlined wingspan sort of thing.
Well, that was some of the original conception, but right. What we determined as far as the impact site where the bodies and the survivor were recovered, that it was more of a pod. Even Rudiak's interpretation of the memo, it refers to a pod.
Right.
And so egg-shaped, size of a Volkswagen Beetle.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Exactly. Anything more, Bonnie?
No, I was going to say that he did say that it wasn't like a flying, like a round thing.
No.
It was shaped differently of what he saw, the pieces and everything, and he said it wasn't a weather balloon.
Right.
He's always said that it was not a weather balloon.
Well, I mean, it's always the tall tale I like to share all the time is that what happened was that the press showed up. General Ramey and Marcel were there.
Yes.
And the press said, "What do you got?" And he said, "We got a flying saucer from another world." And the press laughed at them and said, "Come on, tell us what you really got." Ramey took Marcel back in the room. He says, "Get out the weather balloon. Right, we got to make up a story." So, I mean, that seems to be what I think, because you see in the memo, you see in the telex, and we're learning that none of the story that the Air Force put out in 1994 is true.
And the fact that they are up to 4 official explanations regarding this one event.
I joked
that husbands try that with your wives.
Yeah, 4 explanations. If it's not that great of an event, why were there 4 explanations?
Precisely.
And why in 1994 did they decide that they just wanted to? And they were talking about how the Mogul balloon and the high dive project were the same thing.
Precisely.
And they weren't.
Were separated by years.
Yes.
Precisely. And the point being that as we were providing more and more eyewitnesses, both military and civilian, to the bodies, the small men recovered, they were all the more compelled to come up with an explanation for that, which they did in 1997, just prior to the 50th, and that being the anthropomorphic wooden crash dummies.
Right.
6 feet tall, Project High Dive, Excelsior, 1952.
Right.
5 years removed.
Yeah.
No, sorry.
That was when we met back in 97.
Right.
Talked with the mayor of Roswell at the time. He said the same thing. We still have the facts before us. We still have a lot of work to do.
We have a lot of
work
to do.
We need the historians and the history. That's why it's important that you come out to the International UFO Museum.
Absolutely.
And the Research Center. I know, Don, you're going to be here this weekend.
And
I'm being here this weekend for all of it. I'll be in the parade.
Better to come here for some of the truth in Washington.
Definitely.
Where you seldom, if ever, get it.
That's right. Well, hopefully we're going to get something about Roswell when they start opening the doors. But in the meantime, I'm not holding my breath. Don Schmidt, thank you for being on Ground Zero.
Clyde, always great to be with you.
And thank you all for joining us for our maiden voyage here in Roswell, our live feed. We're going to do another one tomorrow, and it's going to be a lot of fun. We got some special guests we're going to bring on. And stay tuned. We got a lot more right here on Ground Zero. Good night, everybody.